Evil! Evil! Ugh, it took the form of a poster!
It's just an ad.
Abigail just resubscribed on Twitch for 2 months.
Hello, and welcome to the Slightly Wilson Show. I am your host, and today we're going to play your video games. Well, I say this, but today we have been requested to do a real-life video game. That is the winner of this week's video game auction. Sir Ayafus has requested that we indeed do a pencil sharpening speedrun. Now, this was something I was not aware was a real thing. It turns out it is. So indeed, today we must in a timed scenario sharpen 10 of these pencils with erasers, with a sharpener, with sharpen this sharpener here. It counts as single blade. I mean, I'm fairly certain it counts as single blade because it's not got two blades inside it. That's right, Ayafusa. Yeah, that counts. It's the only one I own. It's got two holes. Basically, they're two separate sharpeners tied together. That's how I'm counting it. Yeah, pencil. That's single. Yeah, give it a solid attempt. Honestly, if you could do something else for the rest of the stream, yeah. Well, I don't know. Maybe I'll throw it up in the air at the end. But the thing is, we could do more than one attempt. I did buy 50 home office pencils. Dorbade is both sides. You can sharpen both ways. Yeah, that would make sense. They're so small. What you mean the eraser's so small? Or do you mean the pencil's so small? The pencil's not small. I did double check. We had to have pencils that were exactly... Let me get it the right way around. Let me get it the right way around. The pencils had to be exactly from there to there. 19 centimeters. See? Window? Yeah. 19 centimeters. And you have to sharpen it down to, is it 5 centimeters? So from the tip of the pencil to the eraser has to be 5 centimeters. From what I know. It's going to be hard to hold. Maybe. We'll try. I have prepared a plate to hold my pencil sharpenings. Oh, look, it's because it's green in the center. It's see-through. It's a magical plate. Oh, watch me disappear. Oh dear. Thank you for the teleport, funny man. How are you today? How is everyone today? It is Friday, which means that it's the weekend, basically. And people can... Even if you've not yet finished work, it will be soon the end of work, and then you can enjoy your weekend. Yes. Yeah, the sharpener thingy. But we'll see. Now, for this, I guess we'll try and zoom in. Now, there is one thing I hadn't decided. Since we created this new requesty thing, bid auction thing, should we only ever run it from when we start on Tuesday, or should I start it again on a Friday and then it runs until Thursday? What should we do for the auction thing? Because I've never been able to make up my mind. Now, I think I've set up everything I need. I'm going to put myself on the big screen. Damn it. It still breaks that half the time. Doesn't work the way I want it to. Put myself on the big screen, and then I'm going to try and angle this down. Down, which I know isn't great. I'm gonna try. What's that? That's the mug. I was thinking, what's that glowing there? And then I don't normally do it this way, but that way you can see me holding the pencil. See me holding it. Well, it only works when you stream, so, well, does it though? I mean, the thing is, as long as StreamerBot is on, if somebody redeems it, even if I'm not streaming, I think it will work. Unless there's a... I think there's a rule you could put into it, but then again, that's maybe... I'm not sure. Where is it? Let me have a look. So there's a... What's the name of it? It's called Game Request Bid. That's the one. You can either do a max per stream or a max blah 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 per user per stream. Don't know. I wonder if you put on... If I put max per stream and made that a really high number, maybe it would only ever turn on while it's... Yeah. But redeems only work while someone's live, really? I've redeemed stuff while I've not been live before. Yeah. What's going on here? Well, is that the chair? No, but it's like it's white. That's really weird. It's like it's green screening itself, but it's gone white in that corner behind my elbow. Maybe it's so white that it doesn't think it's green. I can probably fix that. Let me see. I go into this smart link, and then I tweak the color settings of that light that's down there. Put it at 30%. Oh, there you go. Look. If I increase the green contrast level, then it'll do it. However, it then cuts my arm off a bit, but it's better than there being a massive white blob over there. Did you look up any techniques? No, not specifically. I mean, I did look at the Speedrun website you sent me, Leofusa, and I saw like people who managed to do it in like 2 minutes. I think the top time is like 2 minutes, which sounds completely insane. I mean, they were like sitting on the ground and doing it. I'm not going to do that. I'm not going to sit on the ground. Mostly because I have no way of setting my camera up for that. Currently, because it's pretty tightly tied to the desk. Well, I could maybe take it off and like sit it on the desk. Camera on the edge of the desk, maybe. But my room's a mess. I don't want you to see my room. Not right now. It's full of other people's washing. Because my brother filled it with his washing and then he went on holiday. Yeah. Oh well, but we'll do this. But I've made this timer and I've tied it to a hotkey. So if I do, I'll put it on Control S start, it'll start the timer. If I do Control Shift start S again, it'll pause the timer. We can continue it that way. Yeah. And then I've just put it on Control Shift R to reset it. Yeah. That way I can't, I don't accidentally, no, not that one. I forgot that still works. Control R, summoned rose petals. There you go. You just have to do better than 7.5 hours. Who took 7.5 hours to sharpen pencils? 7.5. I mean, because my head's now lower down, it's zooming in on my mouth and not on my eyes. Oh dear. I'll just not use that today. I'll just not use that. I'll raise it back up a bit, I think. I think you'll still be able to see the pencils regardless. Oh, that's taking me off screen. Yeah. One thing I thought I would try though is I thought I'd try the bigger hole. Because basically the bigger hole was obviously for a bigger pencil, but it would mean with a thinner pencil, it would sharpen it at a steeper angle. Is what I'm thinking. Steeper angle. I could be wrong, but in my head that means it would do it faster. Oh, he says as long as you do it, last place is, yeah, so no matter what you do, would you place in top 50? Yeah, because, well, I'm surprised there hasn't been more attempts. I'm surprised there hasn't been more people trying to do it. If it's, I don't know why. I don't know why. But yeah, we'll learn through this. And obviously I need to submit this recording. So I'm going to do this. I'm going to hit start record now. And we're gonna complete our thing. So hello, speedrunning community. My name is Slightly Wilson. I have been challenged by my viewer, Sir Afusa, who won the video game auction redeem to do a pencil sharpening speedrun. I have 10 red pencils, which are, and I have measured them. They are from the end of the eraser to the tip of the, wait, hang on. Is this one slightly shorter? No, it's fine. See, it probably looks weird because I've got it the wrong way around. From the tip of the pencil, right there, tip of the pencil, to the end, it is, no, this one does look like it's shorter. Or am I holding it wrong? They're all the same size. There's no possible way it could be shorter. 19, this is 19, yeah? 19 centimeters. Gasp! No, I think it was the way I was holding it, because I was holding it that way around. Which confusing me. 90 centimeters, and we need to sharpen each of these pencils to less than 5 centimeters. That is the goal. And this is my attempt at this speedrun. So I have a timer, I have it ready. We will pause it if I need to check whether I've sharpened it enough. But I'm ready to go. Should we start with a sound? Drum roll, please. And then, I don't know. I don't know if I have a start sound. Oh, let's just use this. Oh, yeah! Okay, I'm going. I'm going. And I've got a little bowl to put them in. I mean, this is probably not the right way to do it. You're right, there's probably techniques, but I'm doing it this way. I'm doing it this way regardless. Come on. I don't know whether the small one or the big one would be faster. Sharpen, sharpen, sharpen. Yeah. I don't know if I've got more hype music than this. Often some of these tracks are a lot harper. More hyper than this one. Go on, go on. See, one of those dudes in the on the speedruns, he was EVR done by now. I've done 5 pencils already, and I'm still on number one. Still at number one, but there we go. Well, anyway, tell me about your weekends, guys. What are your plans? You know, you can't just leave me sat here. We need to have banter. We need a chat about, I don't know, stuff. I could have used the fight bell. That would have been a perfect start sound. Hey, why didn't I do that? Why didn't I use the ring bell sound? Ow. This is actually going to hurt quite badly. Screw it. I'm going to go back to the other one. I feel like I've got better. Retention on it when I'm going through that one. Ugh. Make sure to sharpen safely. Yes. Nobody wants to accidentally sharpen their face. That would be a disaster if you sharpened their face. I use the top 10 use chalk for grip. Ah, right. That would explain a lot, because it is quite painful. It is quite painful having to do this. I will probably therefore take a short break between each one. That's why we can pause it. That's why I made sure I got a stopwatch I could pause. Ah, because this hurts. And I'm like, I'm not even most of the way through this one. Oh well. Sharpen, sharpen, sharpen. Ah. Maybe we can look up some interesting things to banter about news-wise while we're between pencils. I'd quite enjoy that, actually. Because I'm always looking for like interesting gaming news. Because I used to really enjoy when there was like interesting news about TV shows coming. Are you allowed to pause? It says you can start and stop it yourself. Oh, actually, I don't know if you can pause. Can you look up if you can pause? I thought you could pause, because otherwise, how can you check? How would you check that you've measured it to the right length? I don't think you have to keep the timer on if you needed to measure it to see whether you've done it short enough, whether you were down to 5 centimeters, like. How else are you going to check that without measuring it? Stop and start is for end. Oh, so I can't stop halfway through. I've got to just go all the way through. All right. Ow. You check after doing all 10. But then if you stop it at the end when you've done it, what if one of them's not short enough? Ow. I thought you'd stop and check each one at a time. But then again, I guess that would waste time. No, but that's the reason I thought you could pause it. Fine. Doesn't matter. Ah! I mean, it is going to end up taking me an hour if my hand gives in. Failed attempt. Yeah, it'll be a failed attempt, right? Well, at least I managed to get 10. But the thing is, I want to check if it is 5 centimeters. I guess I can check it without stopping the timer. Is it said that you are allowed to put notches? Is it you are allowed to put notches into the pencils just to show where you have to go up to, as long as it doesn't interfere with the sharpening? You can check so it doesn't fail the attempt, yeah. Well, yeah, I mean, I'll check this one now. Because I don't know how far I am along it. No, 10 centimeters. So I've only half done it, technically. Even though it's now that long, I've apparently only half done it. Because it's now 10 centimeters long. This does hurt. Hey, yeah, yeah, yeah. Well, I will stop anyway and drink some tea. The tea is to help me. It's to help me keep going. It's to help me focus. Focus on sharpening pencils. How did you find out about this AFU? So how did you know about it? Look, like I saw the list. I saw one of them was Small Ant, and look, I know Small Ant gets lots of viewers. Mostly for him doing, well, really weird and stupid things, like watching Ice Melt. The video. What video? The video. It was Small Ant's video, was it? All right, okay. Yeah. Yeah, I've never personally found it very entertaining. But I know he's popular. And him and Ludwig did a pencil sharpen against each other. Oh, really? What, simultaneously? Same time? They should have done it same time, back to back. Really, I don't really find Ludwig all that funny either. Right, sharpen. Ow. Where are we now? Oh, 8 centimeters. I took another 2 centimeters off. It's not enough. Once I've learned how to do one short, then I'll probably be able to do the rest short. Oh, 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 oh. I'm going to cover my fingers in... My fingers are going to be covered in graphite soon and all. Jeez. I'm not wrong, am I? It was 2 centimeters or 5 centimeters or 2 inches. Yeah. Yeah, 5 centimeters. Free to go. Oh. Bro versus bro, which is a competition to see who is the better bro. Three games each person is good at, and 3 games neutral. So 9 games in total. All right. Well, I guess I'm going to have to try and... I didn't mean to press that. Oops. Oh, and then it just stopped. Oh, that was confusing. I'm going to have to put it down here so you can see when I put the pencils down. Oh, you still won't be able to see them on screen. I was trying to say so you could see them all lined up. Prove that I'm not, like, taking ones I sharpened earlier. Oh, come on. 0.5 centimeter. Do-do-do. Yeah, that's right. I mean, I basically have to get them down to pretty much nothing anyway, then. So as close to the eraser as I can. Yeah, that'll count. That'll count. Right, start number two. Pencil number two. Go. I hope you are enjoying something different. Something different? How do you mean? Ludwig Bro vs. Bro is a competition to see who is the better bro. Really? 3 games each person is good at and 3 games neutral. So 9 games total. Huh. Interesting. Instead of a game, it's a speed run. You mean this? Yeah. Well, I gather this became called Pencil Sharpening Simulator. Which, you know, this happens. Everyone makes simulators for everything nowadays. I remember when I saw Rock Simulator. That was pretty cool. It's pretty cool. Is it still white over there? Go away, white. It's not worked. Still there. Aha. I reduce it. Of course, it increases the shadow. I reduce the amount of light. Whatever. I can't do nothing about that. Oh, I've started using the small end, and you know what? It's faster. I've just twigged. It's faster using the smaller. I should have used the small one in the first place. I thought the big one, steeper sharpening, would work, but I think it's the fact that there's better traction. Well, I can hear iron woofing outside, so I think my housemate must have come back. So they hold the sharpener between their feet and sharpen with both palms. Yeah, I saw that. It's about pressure. Okay, maybe I should use more pressure. What sharpener do they use? It can't be one of these, surely it can't be, because there's no possible way that you could push it through the sharpener that fast. 20 seconds of sharpen. I don't really get that. But I mean, I guess if you had it on the floor, but then you're just holding it against the floor, which means you're holding it with the floor, not your body. I think they have something bigger so they can hold it stable. Stable. The actual, like, pencil sharpenings are building up against my hand. I don't know about hole size. Yeah. Like, what if it was a sharpener for trying to think, like, for like a really, really big pencil, would that work better? We're close with this one. Ow. You see, not enough. I mean, you know what, I'm gonna do a little bit more of the other one as well, just in case. That way I can remind myself where it roughly is on the... It's basically when I get to the metal foil bit. It's when I get to the metal foil bit on the pencil that attaches to the rubber eraser. That's what I need to get to. Right. Well, since we're doing this for you, AFUSA, pencil number three, guys. You can give us some interesting news. You seen any interesting news, games and whatnot coming? I caught one today that looked interesting. A puzzle game called, I think it's called Quilts and Cats of the Quilico Country or something like that. It's like a puzzle game. It's a puzzle game where you have to make a quilt. But cats keep hanging around and lying on your quilt while you're trying to solve the puzzle, and you can pet them and everything. That's so random. If you're into cats, then you know. I think it's multiplayer as well. My friend said her game has been developed for 13 years and it finally released. Let me find out. What's it called? Tell us the name. I hope the sharpener doesn't break partway through this, because it feels like it's stuttering as I go. Come on. Right, need some tea. I'd like to get halfway up the board. Not her game, but a game she's been following for a long time. Oh, well, yeah, no, I gather that's what she meant. Not her game, but I mean, yeah. Which game was that then? I do know that my friend's girlfriend, Lisa, who's a lovely, lovely ass, and I've chats with her as well, so she's sort of my friend as well anyway. Not that I've seen them both in a while, but she was really interested in them bringing out Vampire the Masquerade Bloodlines, finally. I think she kickstarted it, actually, but they... Every time it was like, seemed like they were going to release it, they just didn't release it. The last time they released one, which everyone thought was it, then turned out to be that they'd made a Battle Royale book to try and capitalize on the popularity of Battle Royales rather than release Vampire the Masquerade. So she was a bit annoyed by that. We'll just have to see. Oh, not her game, but a game she's been following for a long time. Oh, yeah, no, I read that. Ooh. Sharpen, sharpen, sharpen. Gotta sharpen your pencils, baby. I know the eraser's coming off. I don't want that to happen. It might void it. People are enjoying Pacific Drive. Yeah, that looked good. The one that's like it's a survival game, but also a driving game. And would you say open world? No, not open world exactly. Roguelike maybe, because it's different every time you go through it. Maybe we could try that today, Pacific Drive. Wouldn't mind giving that a go. Looks interesting. Yeah, the eraser on this is like trying to come off. Must be really weak. I hope it doesn't fall off because that would be bad. I guess I could just try and like hold it together if it snaps off. Secrets of Gridia was the game. Secrets of Gridia. I feel like I've heard of it. The fact the eraser's coming off is actually making it harder to turn this one. Come on. Because now I can't like put pressure on it as the eraser's spinning. Screw it. I might take it off. I might take it off so I can actually... Bad eraser. Yeah, it was just spinning around. So I've taken it off. I'll try and put it back on. You can't take it off. I can't take off the eraser. It fell off. Oh, it fell on the floor. It fell on the floor. I'll put it back on. What do you say after? Or do you think I have to do another? Do I think I have to do another pencil? You're saying this pencil's void and I have to do another one. It's not my fault it fell off. Do you think there's a rule about it? Do you know if there's anywhere it says anywhere? They fall off, they must be measured side by side with pencil the same type of the eraser. Yeah, that's right. They said that, yeah. So, because obviously it does happen. So I just need to finish. Yeah, I knew that there was a consideration for it. So the question is now, we'll find out. Ow, still struggling a flipping. Hold it, my thumb's getting painful. The Miikoverse is what I've been doing recently. Miikoverse? Miiko, as in Miku? Or Miiko? What's Miiko? Miikoverse. I am not familiar with this Miiko. Miikoverse. It's getting hard to do now because there's no eraser to hold. This isn't fair. It hurts. It fucking hurts. Code Miiko team has been making a VR chat Twitch friendly with 3D VTubers to collab and meet. Oh, that sounds cool. Ooh. Code Miiko as in Code Miiko the YouTuber. That Miiko. You can mess around with your viewers too. I can't actually get it to turn anymore. Pencil does not want to turn. Come on. Like I said, it could be because the eraser's fallen off. Could be because the eraser's fallen off, so it just does not want to turn anymore. I can't get it to rotate. I'm gonna put it in the bigger one. The bigger one is still turning. So, ow. I'm hoping I'm cutting myself on this broken eraser as well. Because that's what it's done. It's fallen off. Like, snapped off the metal bit. Ow. Fucker. This isn't fair. Ow. Damn it all. Ow. 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 Painful. And it's still nowhere near enough. Looks like fun, sister. It's interesting, Star. I'll say that much. I can't. I it just really, really hurts, this one, because the eraser's fallen off it. So I've got nothing to grip, because I have to get them down to that point. That's where I need to get them. This one is fighting me. Actually, this little metal ring, maybe I can take that off. Yeah. Race has fallen off anyway. Ah. That's the name. Miku is a vocalist. Yeah, that's what I was thinking you were talking about to begin with, Ayafusa. Because I quite like Miku stuff. I was really into Miku when it first came out. I was like, oh yeah, Miku's the best. The idea that songwriters could finally get their songs made without having to pay singers expensive funds. Not to mention, I do see the point as well, the argument as well, that songwriters write songs, but the singer is the one that always gets credit, not the songwriter. Not really. Everyone knows them for that. So it has been really cool, because you ended up with like musicians people were following because they were the songwriter rather than the singer. I mean, the singer as well. People like Miku because she's Miku. I am using my hoodie. No, it doesn't. It's not working. Still slipping. And my hands are black from the graphite. Ow! It fucking hurts! It's not long enough. It's not far enough. This one's been worse than the other two. Look. 20 minutes in. Do you want to know Addo? No, who's Addo? Is that another Vocaloid or something else? Ah, I can barely turn it. I'm actually going to be happy when I got this one done and can move on to the next one. But if another racer falls off, I'm going to be well pissed off. Addo. Ow. Because how can you even turn it when it's... How can you even turn it when you basically got nothing to hold? Ow. come on. The last little bit. Damn it. This is only the third pencil. Ow. Fuck you fucking thing. Ow. You cunt. How much does it measure? I think I'm counting that. I think I'm counting that one. Yeah. Right. There were a Japanese singer that hit number one in Japan charts at age 16. Oh, okay. Don't know if I've heard any of the music. I might have. I mean, hell, if it's been in any anime and stuff, then I'll probably have heard it. Yeah. Ooh. Here we go. Da-da-da-da. She's now 22 or 23. Yeah. I probably have listened, heard some music at some point. I mean, Miku's voice samplist wasn't a singer, though. They were an actor. She used a handsome name Miku to help produce her music. Ah, right. Yeah. Well, that's the thing. A lot of bands have done quite well starting up using Miku, using Vocaloids. Because if they can create a good song, the popularity of Miku helps get the music out there. Ow. This is gonna really hurt. I may not even have the hand capacity to play a video game after this. I don't know. Oh, come. Go. I mean, what was the last challenge you tried to do, Ayafusa? Did you try to do anything crazy? I guess the only challenges I've been doing is this. We've been doing the Baldur's Gate thing. We did, I guess they count as challenges. We did God of War, Last of Us Part 1 and Last of Us Part 2, all on the hardest difficulties. Try to see if we can do them in under 1,000 deaths, which we did do. God of War, though, was something like, I think God of War was the hardest, and we got to like 850 deaths. Something along those lines. I'm gonna have to throw away these sharpenings. They're filling the bowl. Bowl's just full already. And I'm only on the fourth pencil. Ow, for fuck's sake. Ow, I feel like, I think I'm giving myself a blister already on my finger. That or just a piece of skin is starting to... No, it is. It's like getting all backed up. Jeez. Hitting number one without a proper music producer at age 16 is an amazing feat. Well, yeah, damn right. If you can write it, you can write it. I mean, people realised a good 10 years ago that music was the future, didn't they? Digital music. The next one will be people trying to figure out how to get AI music to work. But I don't think it will ever work, really. Not in the same way. You can program them to look at patterns and stuff, but it just I just don't think it'll ever feel right. That could be me, though. I don't know. We'll see. I mean, it was a very interesting Carolyn Tuesday by Watanabe was a very interesting anime on Netflix about music in the future on Mars. What the music of soul is and stuff. I've been trying to reach mastery number level 7 on every champ on League of Legends. Ooh. But sadly, they are changing the mastery system, so that's been thrown out. Oh, really? That's cunt, that is. Yeah, you had a goal, and then suddenly they've changed it. I guess that would be like me with my Final Fantasy thing of... Because I always wanted to anyway. Before I even streamed, I always wanted to get all the trophies on all the Final Fantasies. But I could never bring myself to do it. But if they suddenly like took down the server for the online game or whatever and I couldn't get all the trophies, then it'd be like, oh no. My friend's making an AI singer because he can do music production. Ooh, an AI singer. So a bit like a Miku. Or like a VTube model. That's also a Miku. Ow. I'm really struggling here. Really, really struggling. It hurts way more than I was expecting it to. With a VTube model. Yeah, cool. Ow. It's not being able to have any grip. You're right about the chalk then, because it reaches the point where your hands are just... I mean, I might have to leave the timer going, but I'll probably have to go wash my hands for like a split second after this one. Because they're covered in graphite, and I don't think that's helping either. Ow, got any gloves? No, I don't have any gloves. Especially not the kind that would help with this. It's like, right now I get to the point where it's just the silver metal bit on the eraser. Just the silver metal bit, that bit. And I can't turn it anymore. I guess I can like try and use me hoodie, but I don't think that really works. It works a little, actually. A little bit. If I can use it to just like get to the end, then it will count. Come on. Ow. Come on, you bastard. Ow. Fuck. Yeah, and the fact that you maybe can kind of see it. The skin of my fingers, like, basically getting crushed. I think that's short enough. Maybe. Yeah, that counts. Screw it, I'm gonna wash my hand. I'm literally 2 seconds. I said hello to my housemate on the way past. And the dog, Annoying, is there. Right, that's four done. Carry on. Ay, 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 ay. See, it's fine when it's back to that size. I can definitely get traction. Traction. When I considered putting on trailers in that corner while we were we're carrying on, but that's just my desktop. Ay, ay, ay. I like how it says in the corner, look, the top, that we've apparently died four times in the just chatting category on Twitch. Somehow we've died four times. Don't know when that happened. Hope it counts without measuring every pencil and proving they are all the same length. Well, as you said, we can. I hope you said at the end, as you said at the end, we can stop the timer once we've done all 10, and then we can check the, you know, show in the video every single one of the pencils. That's what we'll do. Yeah, you can do that. Yeah, exactly. It'll still be in the recording, so that'll be fine. Do 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 do. You mean the pre-measure length? Oh right. Well, I mean they're all exactly the same length. So I mean I can show you the measure of every single pencil in the box if you want. They've all come straight out of that box. They're all exactly the same length in the box. It doesn't say the length on the box though. You just hope. Yeah. Well, I mean, I didn't see in the other videos them showing the measuring every single one of the pencils.
Zez Place just Ooh. Raided the show with two of their friends.
It's a raid!
That's right, I stepped up. She's my friend and she needed help. If I had to, I'd pee on any one of you.
Hello. Hello, guys. Welcome to the show. I am sharpening pencils today, Zez. That is today's goal. How are you this fine day? Thank you for the raid. Pencil sharpening speedruns, the sanctuary. Yes. Yes, Eofusa won the game request. Thing. I was curious why you were just chatting today. Interesting. Yeah. Well, I don't think there's a category for it. I mean, I didn't see one. Unless there's like a challenge run category somewhere. Ow. It's seriously hurting my fingers. I might end up with a blister tomorrow, but it's all right. And how are you, Zez and Sanctuary? What were you up to today, guys? You try and keep my mind off the pain. Is there a speedrun category? I don't know. I've never looked on Twitch for a speedrun category. Yeah. I think there isn't, because of the fact that people would need to play, even if they were speedrunning a game, they'd need to be in the category for that game, like legally. They need to be in the same category. Sometimes people are in the wrong ones, but you know, it's one of the ways they negate, like, sometimes music in a game could be copyrighted, but as long as you're in the correct category for it, then they're like, well, you know, it would have been playing the music from the game because he's playing that game. Right, I think that's the right length. Next one. Right, half done, five down, half an hour in. I'd like to see if I can speed up and get under an hour. I'm good. Practicing speedrunning myself. Practicing classic Resident Evil 4. I love that game. Resident Evil. I had to zoom in for a second for that. But I did watch with my housemates yesterday a bunch of games coming. Coming soon. Action RPGs and the like. Some of them I remembered, some of them I forgot. Probably some I've forgotten again already. But there is Dragon's Dogma 2. I think I want to try Dragon's Dogma 2. I've been playing Dragon's Dogma 1. So I'd like to see if Dragon's Dogma 2 is good as well. Yeah. And there's Nightingale. I've played a bit of Nightingale. What else was there on that list? Like a Dragon's already out. Zez, you've been playing Like a Dragon. My housemate's been playing Like a Dragon. Oh, did you like Nightingale? Yeah, I think Nightingale's good. I haven't been able to play with it too much because with my housemates, we're playing Atlas again. I've gone back to Atlas, which hasn't changed that much in the last like 4 years. It has changed, but not much. Yeah. And you only have so much time for survival games. Like I haven't been back to play any Lego Survival in Ages either. But I did Nightingale up to the point where I basically built I built a little wooden shed, and I built pretty much every single crafting station, I think. I played Atlas when it released. Yeah, Atlas was a good game. Atlas was a good game. Gabby approves. Yes. On the EU Asian servers. Yes, go Atlas. Whee. On the EU Asian servers. I thought they only had one server anyway. I thought that's just how it was. How many pencils are we at? We've done five. We've done five and I'm on number six. We're at 35 minutes. So if I can do it in under an hour, I'll be proud. I thought there are separate servers. I mean, there are multiple servers. But then again, the point is there were never many servers for it anyway because of the fact that each server was made up of multiple servers. So that's kind of why the official servers are now, they've made them smaller. Like there's smaller grids. It's a smaller grid system now because each grid was its own server. And when you sailed off the edge of one part of the ocean, you'd sail off one server and onto another. Which was clever. Ow. I don't know if this one's short enough, actually. Shit. Yeah, that looks good. Yeah, that's good. It's good. Next one. Number. Which one's this one? I'm losing track, and my bowl's getting rather full of pencil sharpenings. The pencils are no. The pencils are now in this bowl. Longer than my calculations anticipated. What, the pencils? Yeah. Well, one of them didn't go very well, Gabby. One of them, the eraser fell off, and it got really, really hard to finish that one. Because I still have to sharpen it to the same length, but now a good inch at the end had fallen, or an inch and a half had fallen off. No, an inch. Which made it very difficult to turn. Before, they only had the underground, so I lost signal for a hot minute. The official server to play on. Yeah, they only had... I think they did only originally have one PvP one, didn't they? No, I was in the underground. Oh, you were in the underground. Oh, you've made it to the underground already, Gabby. Oh. Oh. Is your travel going well, Gabby? You'll be pleased to hear... Stuart has arrived home and he's had some pasta. So he's finished his being on trains and now you're on trains. Which I thought was a bit ironic. You got on a train and he got off it. Jeez. I am on the last train now. Yes, the last train. Soon you will arrive at your destination. Ow, this hurts. I'm trying not to complain, but it's like burning. And I'm gonna have to do stretches later on. I'll end up with very sore wrists tomorrow. Well, I've been bombed. Of course, well, the TV's been bombed. I'm over here. I'm on the flat screen TV. But you've bombed the CRTV. Hey, you summoned the colour TV! Hooray! So if anyone wants to, they can change the colours on that. I thought I should have put maybe something on that screen rather than just my desktop. I couldn't think of anything. I think I need to make a...
Hydrate, you bastard! Hydrate!
Yeah, I'll do that. I think I need to make a... What's the... Like a like a logo thing or something, and I can put it on there. Like a Slightly Wilson Show logo, and I can have it on there whenever I'm doing something like this, where we're just chatting on the big screen. Because I could do this on the chatting channel, but I thought it'd be a bit it'd be a bit small.
A viewer has changed the TV settings to ASCII.
Yeah, it'd be a bit small like this. So we'll stick to the big one. Oh, hang on. Oh, damn it, that one's not got a black background. I keep forgetting when I make new TVs to give them a black background so that when there's a certain visual filter on it... Okay, that should be done. Then it would basically still be black behind the telly. Some TVs it works and sometimes it doesn't. Gabby, if you've not seen this CRTV one before, this one here, you can type... exclamation color one and then put in a color and it will change colors or use the channel redeem button. It's a special redeems that show up for it when it's available, when it's visible. Oh, and you can change it to whatever colors you want. I didn't see the redeem. What redeem? Is it not there in the channel rewards? Is there not a color thing? That worked. Oh, I don't know if you need to have a space. Is there not a... I'll have to look. Is it not there? Oh, it's supposed to show up automatically. I don't understand why it hasn't shown up. Try space. Oh yeah, there you go. Yeah. And then you can do color two. And then pick a colour, and it will do the other colour as well. It's one of my favourite TVs, the colour TV. 41 minutes. Right, we're down to two pencils left. So if I do them, two and a half. If I do them just as fast, it should be able to break under an hour.
Yeah,
that's cool. It is. It's good, isn't it? I think it can even do like really weird colors like indigo and stuff. Turquoise. If it's not a color, under an hour is top 27. Hey, top 27 people in the world. Get in there. Come on. It's a shame I got laid back by that one with the racer that fell off. If we do this, maybe I will reward myself and we'll try Pacific Drive, because I really wanted to give that a go. The idea of basically traveling across a crazy sci-fi apocalyptic wasteland in a hatchback type thing that you continuously turn, effectively is slowly turning into like a Ghostbusters car filled with crazy tech in a survival resource gathering video game, but is also a roguelike because every single road trip you do in the car is different. It sounds proper cool. Ow, this hurts though. Damn it. Come on, 43. Though it's struggling. I hope the eraser's not like giving up on me, because it's spinning and it's not sharpening. Let me try using the other one for a second. I think something's gone wrong with it. I don't know what exactly. I think something's wrong with the actual pencil. Damn it, come on, don't break on me now. Oh, it's the erasers. The eraser is spinning, so the pencil's not turning. No, and the blade's not gone. It's the damn... Be more passionate! It's all right. I've got that one under 5 centimeters. It's like, right, next one. Next one. Passion! Passion! Pencil passion, people! The pencil passion is persuading Wilson to... It's not. I mean, what? Sorry. Damn it. One of the LEDs has gotten trapped inside the eraser. No, it's okay. Shake the thing. To eat the shavings. I'm not going to eat the shavings. I mean, I know they're in a pretty bowl. Like, I know. And it looks like it's a nice meal of tasty num-nums. I mean, we could offer them to Iron. If Iron doesn't want to eat them, then... Eat the shavings! How big are they? I don't imagine it'd be very healthy. Do a survey. Should Wilson eat the shavings? Oh, we did make a poll that could do that, didn't we? Didn't we? Come on, I've got 15 minutes, guys. I wanna get this under an hour. Under an hour. Under an hour. Top 27th time in the world. Come on. Little bit of ketchup. Ketchup goes on anything, even pencils. Oh, and I've dropped my sharpener. Ow. Stu's approval has been reduced. Gabby's approval has been increased. Sharpen pencils. You sharpen pencils. Sharpen pencils. Did you add your karaoke back in? No, because we can't do it. We can't do it midway, Stu. Not allowed. We're not allowed to pause the time. It has to be done in one go. Oh. Oh, I'm not allowed a break, basically. Although I did wash my hand, but that doesn't count because that was to try and get the grip back on my hand. It was so covered in graphite, it was not working. Right. Oh, you can break, but the timer has to keep going. Yeah. Oh no. Well, yeah, you're right. I could technically stop, but if I did, that would be like, well, I feel like that would be pussy. Just to stop randomly. Come on. Damn it. Is the graphite still stuck in there? It is. I thought I got it out, but I hadn't. Oh, now. Now I have. It's like some of it snapped off halfway through. Oh, come on. You can do it, Wilson. Ah. Oh, where are we now? No, not there yet. Right now. Yeah. Last pencil, ladies and gentlemen, last pencil. Oh. I'm glad we did not go for 69 pencils. I didn't even have 69 anyway. Oh, this one snapped off again straight away. Come on. No, it's stuck. It's stuck and I can't get it out. Oh, got it. Let's go. Yeah, I don't know if I have a sound that would be suitable for such a moment. Last pencil.
This is amazing.
Oh, jeez. Come on, come on. Final pencil. Final pencil. Ow, 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 you bastard thing. Whew. I should have put on screen what it is we were actually trying to do. Damn it, it's happened again. I don't know why it's been happening with just these last ones, that the graphite keeps snapping off halfway through. Get out me pencil sharpener, you bugger. I can't sharpen me pencils with you stuck in there. Out. Got it. I did get it. Didn't I? No, yeah? No? I can't tell. But it's still going. It's still sharpening. Let's do it, boys. Oh, not again. Again. Have I just suddenly randomly got a bunch of pencils that are shite and they're just... The graphite just keeps falling out. Burr, breathe. Does that come up floating behind the telly? It should do, but... Most of them should do. The thing is, there must be something stuck in there, maybe, that's making it... Yeah, there is. There is something still stuck in there. That's what's making it, like, break. Fuck off your thing. I'm on the last pencil. I'm trying to... Trying to beat this! Baby! Baby! Whoo, whoo, whoo! Ah! Can you see that sticking out? Look at that sticking out, that graphite. It's gotten that bad. Ah. Come on. This one's even more stuck in than the others. Can I use another pencil to get it out? Come on. It's because there is one stuck in there. Under the blade, and I think that's what's breaking it. I think there's multiple tips stuck under the blade. Damn it all! And I'll snap the end off that one. Come out. Ruining my run, you fucking piece of graphite. Why is this happening to me? Wilson does not approve. This is unfair. Some people are using their teeth to hold the pencil. Wait, really? Their teeth? That seems excessive. I don't feel like that would work very well. But I guess that depends. Ow. Come on, you bugger. Turn, 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 turn. Ah, screw it. I have ripped the skin on my fingers. It's literally ripped. No wonder it's stinging so much. This is gonna really hurt tomorrow. This graphite's still not coming out. Hold the pencil, then two hands. Then two hands? Don't know what you mean. Oh, you mean like that? That's what they were doing, I know, but then... I can't hold the sharpener. We're so close to finishing it.
Oh,
Oh. Ow. Jeez. To be fair, you just got about the same time doing it this way and taking a step away. How do you mean? Step away? You mean when I wandered away? I mean, I might try holding it with my hoodie again. Maybe then I wouldn't be doing... When you washed your hands, yeah. Maybe then I wouldn't be doing as much damage to my fingers. Ooh. Ooh. Gabby's approval is now increased. Thank you, Gabby. I'm trying my best. Wilson is trying his slightly hardest. Oh. Come on. We're so close, and we're still under an hour. Still under an hour. Go, 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 go. Sorry for the tear of the skin, but how is it you trying? Well, that just goes to show that I was trying my best. Trying to put pressure on an errand to keep it spinning and sharpening and coming out the hole. Right. Right, where are we? Right, I think we're calling it there. I think we've done it. I will have to go wash my hands again for that. So I've split my skin on two parts of my fingers. Oh, jeez. Woohoo! Yeah, we did it! We're done. GG! Thank you, everybody. Thank you, everybody. But now we need to measure them. We need to check that they're all done. Go disinfect it. I will in a second. We have to finish the recording. We have to prove that we've done it. Because the recording's still going at the minute. We're going to measure the two first with the eraser that fell off. Well, I guess I'll measure one. So there's... I haven't got the focus on it, but that's less than 5 centimeters. Less than 5. And then this is the one that it fell off on. And then it's... That one's... Here you go. So it's definitely smaller. And I'll put these two to the right. And then we've got this one. Now I can't hold it. Less than 5. Less than 5. Less than 5. Oh, jeez. This one looks like it's close, but it's definitely less than 5 still. Oh. Right, another 4. Less than 5. Yep. Out. Less than 5. I'm holding that wrong. That is just 5. Exactly. The eraser, the lead was kind of long. There we go, that's all 10. That's all 10. So I've done it. I've managed to do... I'm pulling the camera back up now. We've managed to do all 10 pencils in less than an hour. Hooray! All right. Yeah, and you're right. I am. I'm going to go seriously clean this now. But, well, no. Give it 1 second. Yay! Thank you. Thank you, Efuso. Jesus, that's still on. is that still on? But before I do, I am going to set up... I'll stop the recording. So this will be the submission. This will be my submission to the Speedrun website. So I'll put that up there later. Let's go to the main... Let's go to the main ching. It's Kristen, you mad lad! Thank you, Chris. I did it. But yeah, I'm going to go have a look and see if we can buy that game as my reward. Because I know it's not expensive. I'll buy it as my reward for doing this. Wait, what? I've forgotten the name. we were just talking about it and now I can't remember it. We were just talking about it. What was it called again? One with the car. One with the car. Pacific. Yeah, Pacific Drive. That's it. Yeah, Pacific something. Pacific Drive. I think. I found it. Yeah, that seems to be it. But they came up with multiple versions. Oh, that's a customization pack. Okay. That's different. Requires base game. So let's just go with the main one now. See what's free this week. Game updates. So I'm getting all this stuff coming up, and I'm trying to click on it. Bye, Hunter. Yes. This game looks cool. It was good to see you wasn't going to run. No. Have yourself a good evening, Zez. Thank you for coming to hang out. And hi, Zelon. Though we do owe Zez a battle royale and a shout out. So we will do that now for him as well. Since he raided halfway through our sharpening madness. Let's have a look. Let's see what we get.
Oh my god, it's my favorite streamer and sidekick. Austin is my new.
Oh, it's the one where there's two of you again.
No.
So that's my not Zez. Right now, Zez will come in a minute. Had. We have a blurb for you guys. Zez plays is the chill 420 friendly gamer making their way through life with a controller in hand. From Persona's Tartarus, Yakuza's Mean Streets, they've leveled up Junpei and Kuryu alike. With Odson by their side, it's all about first playthroughs, LGBTQ+ vibes, and beating baddies into friendship. Join the Verney, and don't forget to wish Hunter a happy birthday. What's with the Bob? What's with the Bob emote? I don't quite get that. These pencil sharpeners are falling off this plate now. This massive plate of sharpeners, look at them. And now I won't eat them. Oh, hang on, it's pulled up that. I was trying to, like, not show you my bank details, so. I'll move that off the screen. Right. Mm-mm-mm. But, yeah, we will now follow up with our first for the day.
Choose your fighter!
Raid Royale. So if you haven't done so yet, guys, say something in chat. Your avatar will spawn below. And then we'll proceed to the battle screen. I'll give you all 2 minutes. 2 minutes, sorry, about five seconds while I click purchase in here and then type in my mobile number. There we go, this should do it. Wait, password? Really? Password? That's annoying. So your details didn't match. Try again. Sure, right. Everyone ready? Let's do this. Right, now they're texting me a code as well.
Three, two, one, go!
This always happens. It's always the way. Everybody fight! I can see Eofusa, Zellion, Hasty, yeah? Super Duper Suski. Wait, there's one there from Hasty. Did we get a message from Hasty earlier? Oh yeah, GG from Hasty Channel. 696. Thank you, Hasty Channel. Where's me text message? They were sending me. Hasty's still in there. Zellion's doing the best though, geez. You've managed to hold on to all of your health. Here's my code. That should do it. Down to Stu versus Zellion. Well, word of passage. What's your word of passage? Stu's snake versus Zellion's link. Oh. No, apparently it's still not gone through. Apparently the bank want me to authorise it. Do they? I've not had anything come up. I've not had anything come up that they want me to log in. Stu's done it! Stuart's won! Good job, Stu. Password is short for word of passage. Ah, right, yeah, word of passage. Is that where it came from, Ayafusa? Really? Really, really? Huh. Interesting. I kind of like that, though. It's kind of cool. Yeah. Nice. Now, I'll need to figure out then why this is still not gone through. We're gonna have a short break now then, while I go wash my hands and we download this game. We'll be back then, very shortly, and then we're gonna try the survival game Pacific Drive for a bit of a laugh. Okay, so I'll catch you all very soon. Until then, enjoy these funny ads.
The coast of Patagonia, and a seal pup makes his way towards the water. Nature is revealed in all its savage glory. For a fully grown killer whale, mealtime can appear as much sport as necessity and can last for up to an hour. For the young pup, it's the ride of a lifetime. Juice my pants, mummy, I'm a happy boy. That's the hit of the whole fruit right there. You know when you've been tangoed.
Oh, come here. Oh!
It's a lemon tango moment.
Here's the true story.
A four friends pick to live in a video game.
And find out what happens when they stop being themselves.
And start being someone else.
Animal Crossing. For Nintendo GameCube.
Nobody wants to trade insects with me, no matter how many notes I leave them.
Why am I always the one cleaning the house and picking the peaches? Where's my big fat hammock time?
So tense.
Welcome to Animal Crossing, the life game that's happening every minute of every day, whether you're playing or not.
So do you want to swap fossils with me later, or?
Rated E for everyone.
You are strong. You are strong. You are unbreakable. You are unbreakable. You are uncrushable. You are uncrushable. You never flake.
Beast ready for anything!
Me and you, and you and me, no matter how they toss the dice, it had to be, the only one for me is you.
Something's gone wrong in the happy-go-lucky world of Nintendo. Introducing Super Smash Brothers, where all your favorite characters go toe-to-toe in one four-player star-studded slam fest. Only on Nintendo 64.
Capcom.
We're the Mario Brothers, and plumbing's a game. We're not like the others who get all the fame. When your sink is in trouble, you could call us on the double. We're faster than the others, you'll be hooked on the brothers.
Thank you, Super Mario Bros. It seems like the only thing you haven't drained is my bank account. For super service, call or text Super Mario Bros. Plumbing today at 929-55-MARIO. Or reach us on the World Wide Web at smbplumbing.com.
I can wait, he says. I'm very good at waiting. And he certainly is. That's naughty. Meanwhile, back in the hallway, well, here we are. Oh, is it just me? Or are things getting a little bit tense?
surreal apple drenching 6.4. Woof!
You know when you've been tangoed.
It's a lemon tango moment.
Hello, Chorley. I think we might use a video replay here.
Super, Ralph. Let's do that.
Oh, yes, we could be in for a quintessential tango test sense. Oh, he's not meant to do that.
That's right, Ralph. He's clapped eyes on a big orange fella and decided to leg it.
And who can blame him? I think I would do exactly the same myself.
Hey, Ralph, he's looking at you now.
You know where you've been tangoed.
Stanley Gimbo had a passion for orange. Everything he owned had to be orange. Orange clothes. Orange car. Orange house. Unfortunately, Stanley was totally colourblind. However, his taste buds were perfect, and only one fizzy drink was orange enough. The whole fruit in Tango was unmistakable. One thing did bother him, though. Why did they put it in a turquoise can?
Tango. Unmistakably orange.
This is how you feel when you eat a bowl of shredding. You can tackle anything. Cold shower. School run. Taking the bins out. Pow! Eat shredding. Ready for anything.
Oh, hello. Welcome back, one and all, to the show. How we doing? I am just getting me bits ready. It is installing. I think it has already finished installing, so that did not take long at all then, did it? Was that 3 minutes? 3 minutes to download and install a video game? Brand new PC game? Not bad, eh? Not bad at all. So we'll just update it. Ooh. Did you enjoy the ads, guys? Yeah, but do you have a favourite one out of the ads that I've got so far? I do need to add some new to the list at some point. That would be good, I think, if I could add some new ones. Let's see then. So, let's just tweak this stream information. Yeah. I'll just change it on here to say pencil sharpening speedrun completed. D. I need a D on the end of that. Completed. In under an hour. So trying Pacific Drive. Nice. And then I'll find the category for Pacific Drive, so we're in the right one. Yeah, that's it. Cool. And there should be difficulties on this, so if there is, we'll try a hard one. How's my hand? Not so bad. I've washed it. I put plasters on the fingers where it's ripped. My skin. That's a little, but it's not so bad. I'm sure it'll be alright. It wasn't like it's completely ripped. I completely ripped my fingers. I just took off a layer of skin. So it's gonna be raw for a while, but it should be perfectly fine. Don't feel guilty, AFE. So it was my technique on how I chose to sharpen the pencils. It's entirely my fault. No one to blame but myself. Okay, let's have a go at this. The finger is raw. I guess the one thing I do need to remove though is the countdown timer. Or should I leave the countdown timer there for the rest of the stream? just in case it confuses people as to why it's there. Yeah. Oh, hang on. Have I got the right category? I have, haven't I? Got the right category? Back on the chatting screen, is it updated correctly to the right category? Yeah, look, it's down there, Pacific Drive. Okay, yeah, so that should be fine. Should be fine. And then we'll change it to my correct layer. It's gonna go blank for a second. But when I press go, then we should get the game come up on screen. Yes, leave the timer on screen. Okay, we'll do that. Oh, it's trying to install. Well, this is interesting. It's installing a Epic Online Services overlay. I don't know what that is. But I guess we'll find out in a second. Oh, and any idea as to why the colour things didn't appear? I don't really know why that happened. Well, what I'll do is I'll enable them anyway. So they'll be in the channel redeems now. So you can change the colours on my colour TV. Yeah. Could make it a bit smaller. Well, the timer. Yeah, I'll have to go to the actual layer then. That's not the layer. That's the layer. And then I can shrink it. That's not hard. A bit smaller. I made it very small. It's okay. Game's still booting? Yeah. Okay. Should be working. Just give me a second. I need to move that to there. And then you should be able to hear the game as well. Right. Is it working? I've put it on show PC games. Ooh, I'm getting some lag. I'm getting some lag on my stats, which means that it's a very demanding game, apparently, then. Video. What we got? What can I adjust here? DLS, it's not got DLSS on right now. Weird. Ultra quality, balanced performance, balanced. Let me hit apply. Apply?
Tyre Thews are just gifted 10 Twitch subs.
How do you apply it? Because it's not worked. Ayafusa, 10 subs, jeez. 10 subs, everybody, from Ayafusa.
What? Did we just become best friends?
Yep.
I'm sorry for the lag, though, that, like, the screen is lagging. I know. I don't know what, this game must be quite taxing. Now I'm like, should I have bought this on console or something? What can I... Borderless window, screen percentage, vertical sync, motion blur. Anti-analyzing. What can I tweak to make it not be my computer as processing so much? Mirror shadow quality. Medium? Fog rendering? Grass rendering? There's normally like a general... Oh, maybe put the shadows down to medium. It's weird though that it's already doing it when the game hasn't even started yet. And yet it's already like chewing up my computer's processor. GPU. Post-processing. Why can't I do it? This is going to be shit if I've bought a PC game that just doesn't run very well at the same time as OBS. I guess, I could just try and, like, drop everything to medium. It's the fact it's not letting me click apply yet, though. Which I'm finding odd. Maybe it won't fix it until I start, like, the game itself. DLSS sharpening. I don't actually need to tweak that, though, do I? Motion blur, vertical sync. It's not improving, is it? Well, we'll just hit play and we'll see how it does. Customize the settings before you start. I just did customize. Didn't seem to freak out on us. Start game. Right, let's see. Oh wait, oh, it's cleared up. It suddenly cleared up. But now it's gotten bad again. I didn't think this game would be too demanding. But we are getting quite a lot of frame drops now. Grr. This is always a pain when something like this happens. Anyway, we'll switch over the sounds to the game. In 1955, the government walled off a section of the peninsula to establish the Olympic Exclusion Zone. For 30 years, the zone's borders grew until the government withdrew and sealed every access point. What happens inside was never disclosed. Okay, so game in. What I might do is I'll turn off the preview. That can sometimes just fix it. I can't see myself, but that doesn't matter. That's partly why I have the phone for. No, I'm still getting frame drops. Obviously a very demanding game. I should have got it on console. Every time I think, oh, it's going to be fine, and I buy a game on PC. Ultra performance. I don't know whether I want sharpening on at all, really. And I don't know which is a better anti-analyzing method. I do wonder whether it's... because it's trying to do too many frames. Normally when I do these, right, there's an option to basically limit the frame rate. There doesn't appear to be one in the game. Doesn't look like it's too bad. Keeping an eye on it. More than the game right now. Driving me car, anyway.
Sulfur and smoke.
That tunnel's blocked off.
Blows through the snow. Smells like money. Rivers for spines. Between the dry pines of bones unbecoming.
Wipers! Oh, it doesn't turn as fast as I thought it would. Don't really need the wipers right now, though. Is it going to be raining? So maybe the problem is that I've lowered the graphics so much that I can't see the rain. Well, I'll keep the wipers going. I don't understand what it is that's making it so bad. Is it not optimized super well? Maybe I'll turn off some of these distant shadows and fog ones. Detail, distance. But there's a lot for mirrors, which obviously aren't necessarily relevant. Shadows, post-processing, foliage, textures, view distance, and the analyzing. Try that one again. Oops. Oh, and I'm still only getting 44 frames. The problem is, quite often, it's just that the PC gives the game higher priority than the streaming software. I feel like it should do that. Well, obviously, I'd prefer to tell the computer to give the streaming software priority first. At least it's still running over 30 frames. The radio's going funny. Oh. Warning. High. What's that say? High R levels. Faculty. Facility. Extreme caution. Further increase. Directed by C2B. We've arrived somewhere. A muddy track. Interesting. What the hell? Did some of those rocks start floating? That's not very good. There as well. Something very weird going on in this area. Try to work my way through it. Oh, the power's gone. Appear to have been sucked into a rift. Well, that's not great. We're not in the car. Interesting. I thought we spent the whole time, or pretty much most of the game, in the car. The Olympic exclusion zone, which does not look very happy. Bits of Kara floating around. Is that my car? Is this all that remains of my car? It's been split into pieces. Down here in the muck.
Caution.
We're walking on foot now then. Maybe we find another car. I guess my car's dead. I guess it's completely screwed. Kick the branches. Oh, there is
someone out there. Hello. What a sworn I.
Tobias.
Never mind. Francis, the radar's acting up again. You were supposed to tune up this piece of junk years ago.
Pick up the wheel and put it on the car, right? Right bumper. Install summer tire. Right, okay, in the car. Wipers. You already learned what they are. Turn on. The car in drive.
Following Francis Cook, located in mid-zone sector B. Do you read me? I'm picking up your distress signal in the outer zone. It looks like you're somewhere around sector E. Hey, Francis, come here. Yes, it's urgent. Leave that interferometer alone for a second. Something is out there.
It's not steering very well. It's trying to turn left only.
Hey, we got a live one. Hey, do you copy? Hello? Hello? Is this thing working?
They don't have a transmitter. We won't hear a thing back.
Huh. But if they're stranded, could they mean... they're from outside? They're a creature. Hey, how did you get through the barrier wall?
It's not dry very well.
In ages and live to tell about.
And if we don't get them to safety, this one won't either.
That's a good point. Hey, you're in serious danger. The instability's closing in, and it's going to scramble you quicker than beef in a blender. You close the shelter is a few miles east. Get there however you can, and be quick about it.
Drive east to find shelter. Well, the car is seriously fighting me. Honk. Lights on. Oh, they do, they turn on. No, I'm having such trouble making the wheel turn. I guess the car's that banged up. Oh. Barely drive it. Come on, you daft thing. Fucking go. Go. Drive for daddy. Ah, come on, you big beast of burden. It's not having it, is it? It's weird, it's like it drives fine when I go into reverse, but not while I'm in forward. Come on, no. Yes. Ah! I don't understand, I'm not pressing a key or something, am I? That's making it... harder to drive. The other car drove fine. There's another car up ahead. Oh, this one's at it. Siphon fuel. The other car. Okay. Open. I didn't realise you could just get in and out cars. Didn't know that was going to be a thing. This area's weird again. Oh, but this one's a bit run down. There's no engine. Oh. Check your trunk for a fuel can. I missed that part. Is that a fuel can? It's like stuck by some weird green, bluey stuff. Ugh. Siphon fuel from the broken down car. Really think it has any fuel left in it? Yes, he's got a siphoner. little more. Hey, fill your tank. Where's my tank? On the opposite side? Yeah, there it is. Just pouring it in. Is that enough? Okay. And then store it again. What is that? Get in the car. Don't like this. Turn on. Ah! Something's happening. I don't like it!
Wait, hold the phone. There it is again, that blip on the spectrometer. I've seen that waveform before, but where?
We're out of it, just.
No kidding. Could it be? A remnant?
That can't be. There hasn't been one in decades.
Look at that spectral fingerprint and tell me that doesn't match the remnants exactly.
No. What we should be looking at is how fast this creature seems to be moving.
Huh. You know, if I didn't know better, I'd say they're going about the speed of a... No way to not tell me. They found a remnant and it's a car this time?
The remnant that's a car.
No one's had working wheels in here for ages. Boy, I'd kill to know how a combustion engine's still chugging away out there.
Okay, let's not get ahead of ourselves. First, the breacher needs to get
so safety. Where are we? In some kind of weird pocket dimension.
In my heart of hearts, I already know. They're
back, baby.
Ah! This car steals like a cow. And I can't. And I'm stuck in this whatever it is that I don't like. I don't like whatever it is. Come on, turn, you daft thing.
When you find that shelter, go on and let yourself in. Now, Albie ain't gonna like you poking around in there, but better to face a bad side than let the zone eat you alive.
The zone eats you? Is that the shelter? It's not that, is it? No. No, I don't think so. Let's carry on. Come on, car, you can do it. We're almost there. Up the hill. Oppie's Auto Shop. Get inside. Okay. This car is still not driving very well. That's okay. Turn off. Turn off the car. Get out. The stairs upstairs. Right. Hello. Anyone here? No. Right. Breaker. We've got power, boys and girls!
Ah, God. Who's there? God, the shop. God, it's been breached. You've got 5 seconds to get the hell out before I... Ow! Oh, my head.
Where's the voice coming from?
It's an emergency broadcast.
Hello, attention. This message is for Dr. Ophelia Turner. Send a breacher to your garage on official zone business. Now, we have it on very good authority that this person is in possession of a remnant, which has taken the form of a car, and, well,
Get off the remnant thing. She's not gonna care.
Right, like I said, super official zone business. Protocol, demands that you keep them alive until we can get them to safety. Now, if you do not comply, I will occupy this broadcast channel with a recitation of the entire collection of poems I've personally written. That's 10 years and 17 volumes and...
Tell her that voice goes like a nail gun to the skull. So, another breacher, huh? How do you outsiders not understand that Arda didn't build that 300-meter wall out there for fun?
Oh, it's missing a tire.
The unfortunates who got zapped through.
Well, that's why it doesn't like turning. Look, it's missing a tire. I drove all the way here on free tires.
For trespassing, and I'd kindly like you to get the hell out of my zone.
Is the voice coming out the radio?
Unfortunately, the barrier wall is as fortified against breachers trying to get in as it is against anyone or anything trying to leave. We have to find you a way out. So you might as well start by fixing up that car. Just don't break anything in my shop with those soft hands of yours.
Soft hands? All right.
What? You need help? There's a headset somewhere in the garage. Put it on. The built-in diagnostic will tell you what needs fixing up.
There's a radio. Well, here's a diagnostic helmet. Headset. I don't know what all these batteries are for. Am I supposed to drive the car onto here? First aid station. Oh, it just healed me. Nice. Oh yeah, pull the car in. Okay. So we need to go get the car. Steel door damaged. Okay. Turn on. Mm. Hang on, is that another wheel there? Is that another wheel? Well, if it's going to help me pull the car in, then I might as well get the wheel. Summer tyre. Okay. Left front wheel. Hey! The car's now got four wheels! It can actually drive now! Yes! Mostly. Go on, car. Go on, car. This game looks wanks, this dude. I have a very funny... as far as I've heard quite a lot, but it gets really interesting, this game. Right. Is that it? Is it in? Parking sensor. It still doesn't turn very well. There must be something else still wrong with it. Okay. But I'll turn it off. Put it in park. Get out. Crude door. Open headset OS. Blueprints. Crude door. You need scrap metal, plastic, duct tape, and glass shards. Search the abandoned car's trunk. You need a pry bar. Oh, okay. Could also steal some fuel again? Oh, I can, but I'd need to get the fuel can again, I guess. It has a steel door. I don't know if I can use that for anything. Are you going to scrap other vehicles to get their parts? Toolbox. Which has a mechanics kit, pry bar, and some duct tape. How do I transfer? Oh, and then it fits in your backpack, similar to like a... Similar to Resident Evil. Want a few of these on standby to handle engine or wheel trouble. Can I rearrange, or... Yeah, you can. Do I have to, like, equip it or something? Oh, I do. Okay, well, in that case, I'll put the... resources and stuff like that down. You can rotate it? Yeah. Down the side there. I'm going to have to click on these things all the time. Right, pry bar equipped. Then I can, what, pry stuff open? Yeah. All right, and inside there is glass shards. Road flares. Cheap, equipable light source, useful in a pinch. This powerful potassium-based incendiary burns bright and burns brief, even in the wettest of conditions. There's a fair few of those and all. Right. Again, I can rearrange some of this stuff. Yeah. I can acquire the mechanic kit, but I don't really know exactly what it does, so I'll leave it for now. Is there anything else we can do? Oh, I'm smashing the panel. Turned it into plastic. There you go. There's another resource. Doesn't look like it damages the pry bar. Oh, it does. It damages the pry bar. So, I suddenly looked down and realized that it is damaging it. Oops. Don't use the pry bar for that then. Friendly dumpster. What makes it friend? Whoa! What the hell? What the hell's in this dumpster? Is it alive? We're flipping Torx slightly. It's just dropped me a scrapper. The heck is a scrapper? Don't tell me this is what I use to like actually get stuff. Essential, open log. Wait, logbook? Logbook. Oh, there is a logbook page. In car controls. Should all fail. Is that? Radio headlights, wind light wipers, all fail, honk the horn. You can remap the controls. Power abilities. Certain components and equipment you will install on your car have abilities you need to be activated. You can assign controls to up to four of these using the small panel on the left side of your dashboard. The auto shop is your base of operations. You're safe there, so you can take your time between drives to fix up your car, craft parts, and research new upgrades. While on foot, you can walk, run, crouch, and jump. You can also pick up, drop, and throw kick items to certain objects you come across. Yeah, we did have kick, didn't we? Gonna kick this? Doesn't really work. Not in the same way. Get into the... Don't have a thing yet. No, it's also putting the flare and stuff on the, on, like, the equipment. There's the scrapper, so is this what I was supposed to use? Yes, probably. Scrap metal. Glass shard, scrap metal. There's another tire. Can I take the tire as like a spare, maybe? Not. Duct tape. That's quite random though. Why would duct tape suddenly come out? What did I just... Oh, I accidentally dropped it. What did I do there? I think while I had it out, oh, his left trigger's throw. Tap is drop. Right trigger's use. Okay. I think it says we need more plastic. Well, there's some. Plastic, duct tape, scrap metal. Rubber and a gear. Bit weird the way the resources come out. Interesting though. Yeah, without a torch I can't easily like look at this one, but then again it looks like there's nothing left on that one anyway. There's a computer over there that's still on. Hello. Can I interact with you? Not. Scrap the computer! They gave me some electronics. Door. Locked. Door locked. Even though we can go inside. Workbench, okay. Jeez, there's an awful lot of stuff you can make then. Oh no, they're different categories. Oh, tool, car maintenance, etc. Right, we needed a crude door, didn't we? Is that what it was after? Tier 1. Craft. Install the crude door. On the side, yeah? Okay, right trigger. What's with the Y? I don't know what the Y is for. Get the repair putty from the locker. There's a lot in here, though. There's a lot in my pockets now. That's a gear. That's rubber. Copper wire. Electronics. There's a lot of different types of resources. Scrapper, scrap metal. Those are our flares. Over here we've got a spare tire, right? Repair putty. First aid kits. I know I've kind of filled up my backpack, but I might need all of this, so I'm taking it. What's that? Items insecure, risk of loss. What's insecure? What's insecure? Oh, these ones, they can't, right, they can't fit like that in that pocket. Huh. Oh, okay. I'll leave the spare tire for now then. Okay. Storming something fierce outside. Open inventory, and we want the repair putty, did it say? That one. Equipped. Used to repair the car in general? What do I do? Just click on it? Is that what this Y does? No. Oh, I took it off. Oh, right. That's what that means then. Why? Right trigger to use. Oh, it is. It's repairing the panel. Steel panel. Anything that's like a bit brown. Like this steel door that's really, really weak. It's like magic putty that just repairs the car. Have I still got more or am I out? Oh no, that's only just used up one of them. Okay. Trunk storage, trunk crafting. There's a bunch of stuff that we just don't have yet then. Fuel can. I find anything else that's a bit damaged. The steel door's got a little crack in it. Does that mean it's weak? It's the bumper. Nine, 100%. Okay. Well, this tire's scan the flat tire. Left bumper. Oh, we scanned the wheels, and it's worked out that one of them's not right. That one there apparently has got like a little red thing on it. Loose. Fixed with mechanic kit. Okay. Well, I've got a mechanic kit. This one here. Equipped. And then how do I use it? Oh, did I? No, I just put on the gear, not the mechanic kit. That's the mechanic kit. Use. Right trigger. I did. It fixed it. Oh, and then it got destroyed. Okay. Last long then. this one wants us to fix it with the sealing kit. How do I... Oh, it says repair the flat by crafting and using a sealing kit, or use the spare tire. And I'd like to see if we can bring the spare tire with us. But... pry bar, mechanic kit, sealing kit, rubber, duct tape, etc. Hey! So the tyres are now fixed. Outfit the car. Install the cardboard boxes in the trunk. These ones. Trunk storage. Yep. Then the craft mat in the trunk. Okay, pick it up. Install the arc device?
There's a little prototype of mine in the garage. The arc device. Hook it up to your car, wherever it'll fit.
Passenger seat, eh? Okay. What is that?
This beauty won't just be your tour guide. It's your North Star and the only way back to safety. Heck. You should consider it the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit if you plan on staying alive. That's how important this thing will be to you. Yes, that's my very own invention. I'll tell you more about it if you live long enough to use it.
Arrival road, exit roads, anchor signal. Okay. Seems it can do some interesting stuff. Here. Blueprint for a gear. And a blueprint for an impact hammer. Refuel your car. Oh, there's an actual pump. Okay. Which is there. Full. It's an interesting overlay. It's a little busy in some ways, but at the same time, it gives you all the information you need. Put that back. I guess he's just saying that's full as is. Yeah. Can I, though, before we do anything else, can I use it to fill the gas can? Yes. Good idea. Throw the switch to charge your battery. That's what this is. Oh, okay. I did wonder what this was.
If you're all set, take a look at the projector against the wall.
Projector? What this? Route planner.
This is the zone. Within these borders, all matter has lost the ability to hold a constant physical state. What that means is the shape, size, and makeup of just about everything constantly changes. A mile of grass can turn into 10 miles of swamp in the blink of an eye, and it does. Constantly. It's caused by something we call instability. We're completely surrounded by it, and once you've watched it chew through entire mountain ranges, you'll understand that you don't want to get anywhere near it. We can only survive in here within pockets of stability. That's what you're standing in now. And that's what you're seeing mapped on the route planner. If we're going to find you a way out of the zone, you'll need to build a new antenna. Until then, you won't be able to detect stabilized routes beyond your immediate area. So, you've got to go hunting for parts, and that means taking a drive. Go on, pick a route. The arc device in your car will then show you where you need to go.
Okay. So we've got to pick a route using this. I'm just wondering what was going on here. Giving us information about the car. Doesn't look like there's any other any other doors or things we can use or stuff to pick up at the minute. My backpack's basically full. Got, yeah, that can't go there. Should put that down the side. It's tricky this to know where to, like, where you're going to want to end up putting things. You'd end up messing around with this for ages. But righto, yep. Keep the scrapper with us. I don't think we want to leave anything here. I don't know what the gear is. What has teeth and bite but no jaw? Probably lots of things, actually. This gear's one of them. We did pick up some blueprints. Can I craft anything with them before we go? Yeah, the impact hammer. Although, no, it needs a... needs a gas cylinder? Missing ingredients. Can you make the gas cylinder? You can make gears. I've already got two. If I pin it a checklist, is it going to help me find the resource? There's the spare wheel, which... Oh, we saw we might be able to put stuff in the boot now. There's a crafting mat you can make some stuff out then. And there's cardboard boxes, yes, which has some storage. So I could put the repair putty in there, for example. Might need the road flares. And I might need the scrapper in general. It says two at the top, so I don't know what that means. Does that mean I'm carrying two scrappers? Or, no, that means that's what it's assigned to as a quick slot. Okay. Yeah, I get that. So I'm guessing this impact hammer is the thing we need. Wasn't anything else left in there, was there? The thing we that's going to count as a sort of weapon. If there isn't anything else around I can use, it's going to be tough. Let's just double check outside again quickly. Some plastic again. There's a radio. Battery. There's a battery. No other random items about. I'm sure we're going to end up finding tons of stuff as we explore in the levels. Definitely do one before we finish, because I'm excited to see what crazy stuff happens in a level. Do that then. There's my carrying now before we leave though. No, don't crouch. I don't need to press up to do first aid. I need to. Oh, there we go. I was checking in here. Oh, that's just another resource. Okay. Definitely not found what we needed. Yeah, I can make a repair putty, but. We'll hang on to the resources for now. Oh, no, I almost forgot. Yeah, spare wheel. So if I pick up the spare wheel now. And I can put it in the car. These cardboard boxes have quite a lot of space in if they could just randomly have a spare tire in it. I might as well just keep it in the top. Route 1 to here.
Off you go. Make a left out of the garage, follow the access road.
Okay, here we are. Let's head out and see what occurs. Cool, it's turned around so I can use it on this side. Follow the door up, take a left, take the access road. The inside's already looking proper trippy. Like cables running through the car now. It's all part of this arc system. Turn it on. Oh. The car is not going anywhere. Oh, wait, hang on. I put it in park. Okay, now it's in drive. Or, as we say in England, I took off the handbrake. Hang on, I guess it's America. I would drive on this side of the road. So is this the entrance to the levels? Yeah, travel to here. Traveling to our first location. Outer zone. Petrol stability.
Okay, newbie. I'll keep this simple. Don't want to over-refine those materials by any means necessary. No one's coming back ever again, so go on and take what you need.
Find a plasma
homes,
generator.
Outpost facilities, they've all been abandoned
cars,
since the zone was decommissioned in 87. Most of those structures
collect materials and craft replacement
the next time
parts.
The instability scrambles the area. So loot to your heart's content. Just loot away.
So this is where the roguelike part comes in, that every single time you go to an area level,
the arc device is picking up
it's completely different.
Generators nearby. Your headset has a built-in scanner. Use it on the plasma generator, and it'll figure out the tools you need.
Right. Stop it. Engine. Or turn off the engine to save power. It's vroom vroom, King Ghost Wolf. Hello, King Ghost Wolf. How are you this fine day? Is this a plasma generator? I think it is. How the hell do I
look
get
at
this
you
out?
Out of the zone, all on your own.
Looks like it's ripe
impact
for the picking.
Hammer. Right.
Can't get at it with your hands, though. An impact hammer will do the trick.
There it is, gas cylinder. It was glowing as well, wasn't it? Oh, a backpack. Oh, so I've now got a pack and a backpack. Oh, no. It's just showing me what's in the backpack. All right. There you go. Transfer. Having a lot of materials now. That's fine. They're still fitting in my backpack at the minute, so we're good. How are you, King Ghost Wolf? It's Friday. You got much planned now. Much excitement. I feel like I want a light of some description. There's a bunch of resources. Oh, a transmuter. What is that? Doesn't tell me. Transmute a pry bar to a lead platelet. Is that what this does? Okay. Well, I have one pry bar that's pretty damaged. So let's put it in. See what happens. Oh! Did it just spit the pry bar back out? Didn't work, really. Try again. Yeah, it didn't work. Wonder why not. Wonder why it didn't. Am I missing something?
Hey, driver. I bet you're dying to hear all about the remnants by now.
Can you not? I'm a little busy trying to keep them alive.
I'll keep to the basics, I promise. They deserve to know what they're getting into.
Fine. I'm giving you 60 seconds.
That is not nearly enough time to get...
55 seconds and counting.
Okay. The remnants, in short, they're old objects that do all sorts of weird things. They bind themselves to people, and you're the latest victim. You and the car are inseparable now, so get acquainted.
Oh, that's weird.
Once the remnant is bound to someone, they become gradually more obsessed with it. It takes over the victim's mind until they go crazy and run off into the zone with it.
What?
No one has ever been able to resist its siren call. That fixation is probably worse.
So they're saying I'm
going to
become obsessed with the car. So much to do in the new Final Fantasy. I haven't even got past chapter 2 yet. I'm getting a pepperoni extra cheese calzone for dinner. That sounds banging, he goes. Calzone in Final Fantasy. Fantastic.
Now I'm splitting the transmissions going to your receiver. Anything critical to your immediate needs will broadcast directly and immediately to your radio and headset. Anything not mission critical will be on a low priority frequency. Those transmissions will be recorded and indexed for you to listen to at your leisure. And by low priority, I mean just about everything that comes out of Tobias's mouth.
I'm trying to figure out what this machine is then. The installation plan for these newer compact LML converters, along with my resignation from ARDA. My favorite pastime of my peers to gripe about the youth of today. There's a bunch of stuff there about the transmuter, but it doesn't tell me anything about it. It doesn't tell me how it works. That's weird. Bound items. Loose wheel. Essential. A friendly dumpster wouldn't be your best pal in all the zone if it wasn't handing out things it really thinks you really, really needed. Did you keep in order to safely make it for your next leg of the journey? Best pal status to be confirmed. Friendly dumpster. A bunch of stuff, yeah. But not this. Yeah, it's interesting that it's not working. Maybe it needs to be a much higher quality one. Right, yeah, we should be able to make this hammer now. So if I go over here, craft mat, do impact hammer, craft, then I'll have made one. So it says I should be able to... Oh, is this it? Okay, it's big. Is it going to literally smash it? You ready? Oh, it did smash it. Which gave me some glass, as well as the copper wire and plasma. Plasma, I guess, is what we needed. How's my day? It's been good. It's been long. I have slightly injured myself because we just did Fusa's request for the week, as he won the game auction, request auction. So we had to sharpen pencils, which took us some time. Took us a while, but we did it in less than an hour in the end. Yeah. Still trying to decide whether I want to put any of this stuff in the... Yeah, really. Okay. Well, I got the hammer. Smash that. Put it there. Oh, these lights. You take these? You can scan a lot of stuff. I should probably scan quite a lot of things because it might be worth scanning. Recommended tool, hand vac. So it's recommending I use a hand vac to get materials out of it. Let's check the opposite side. Is this the same? Light housing, vapor lights. Welcome visitors. You don't have an electric one. An electric sharpener. Oh, no. But the thing is, you have to hand sharpen them anyway. Oh, it's locked, but it's saying that I could smash in the door. Locked, fix pry bar. So it's suggesting I use the pry bar on the door. Oh yeah. Okay, yeah. So the pry bar does, it opens doors. Nice. We've got a crate. which is got some materials. Nice. Is that duct tape? Because we've got some more duct tape back. There's another backpack that's locked. No, it's not locked. Why was it telling me fix pry bar? It's not locked at all. I don't understand why it's giving me that description still. Because they're not locked. Maybe the game's glitched. It's a little weird now. What's that one? I missed what it was. Evergreen paint. Oh. Found some paint. I mean, that's not a terrible thing to have. And we need to smash plasma generators and find 5 thingamies. So here we've got chemicals. It's quite dark, but we're still managing to find stuff. Ooh. Ardor crate. Oh. Resources, it's perfect. It looks like they can stack quite well. I don't know if there's a max stack limit, but I'm glad it's letting me pick most stuff up. Around the back, there was a generator, but it's already been smashed. There's another car. We already found that we can use a scrapper to get parts off these. Have you heard of this game all yet, King Ghost? It's since we finished the pencil thing, I've been trying this because I've been looking forward to it for a while. It's called Pacific Drive, where it's effectively a survival game, but it's also a roguelike. So you drive across the Pacific Northwest in a car that you slowly improve using materials you gather. So there's an awful lot of survival building in it. I don't know why I'm scanning stuff. It seems to count. And then I'll smash the panel. Trunk interior. So there is stuff in there as well. Yeah. Scrap metal. Is any scrap metal I collect? It's going to help. It's going to help us repair the car to working condition. There's a spare tire. I mean, I should probably take that. How can I take it? Can't just take the tire off then? No, that's a shame. There's a tire there as well. Wrecked car. Sodium vapor light. So it's showing everything that I've scanned, so I seem to be able to get quite a lot of information scanning stuff. But oh, plastic, I just missed that. I don't know how to get the tire off. I could try the pry bar, but I bet you it won't work. Could be wrong though. No, all that happened was I destroyed my pry bar and damaged the tire. Great. That was not good. There's another building here, and then we'll have to have another little drive around. I'd love to get on a Final Fantasy, but we still need to finish Baldur's Gate first. It's alright, I will get around to it, definitely. And here we have resources, cabinet with resources, loot. Every single bit of loot we can find. There's a locked building. I mean, I might be able to make a new crowbar in a second anyway. Pry bar. Huh. There does not appear to be a way inside. Surely there must be a door somewhere. Radiation hazard. That doesn't sound good. Could I drive one of the fence panels down? I don't think I can jump over it. I mean, there's a little computery thing there that might give you some decent electronics. It may seem foolish to say, "Oh, can I drive it down?" But you know what? It might work. So I'm gonna give it a go. What did I just walk past? It suddenly highlighted something. Panels. Oh, I can just open it anyway. I should have done that before. Oops. Good, scrap more stuff. But let's have a look. What can we make? Can we make any more parts? I mean, it's got panel there, door. Steel door, crude door. Oh, you can make better ones. Right, I see. So maybe we want to be able to put steel doors on rather than build spare tires and... Oh, yeah, because the spare tire and summer tire. Summer tire is better than a spare tire, maybe. It doesn't quite give me lots of information. We still missing some... Still missing some parts? Yeah, I think we're missing a headlamp. Got a bumper at the front. We haven't got a bumper at the back. Selling, that's missing. Seemed to say it was missing a back, like a boot lid, but then it doesn't seem to care anymore. Now, maybe because we've got all the stuff in the back. Crew panel, crew bumper. Two duct tapes, etc., and a crude headlamp. Twitch being Twitch. Two VIPs. Oh, my bad. Wait, is there two VIPs? Is there? Oh, no, there's... You got the chair. Stu's got the VIP, because Stu's just won. Stu won the Battle Royale. Wait, was it Stu that won the Battle Royale? See, now I can't quite remember. I'm gonna double check the other screen. It's still a bit upset. Yeah, he did. He did win. I thought he'd won. Yeah. I bought this on PC and it's eating the computer processing power. Should have just got it on console. I think it is on console as well. Don't know why I didn't. Hello, Stu. Ooh, a coffee. Thank you, you godly man. I've been delivered a coffee, ladies and gentlemen. Great. Because we're not gonna quit this area until we've completed checking about first. I put the paint in the car. I don't think we need to carry the paint around with us. Thank you very much for the teleport. Nice. Funny man. Hey! Steel door. Yeah. I don't understand what the little symbol means. Oh, I've scanned it. Trunk door. Yeah, it doesn't have a trunk door. Okay, let's make these parts then. So if I make a crude door, crude panel, a crude bumper. Wait, no, not a panel. I think we've got a full set of panels, haven't we? Actually, it looks like it's missing a panel there. Let me scan the panels and it will tell me. Wrong button. That one. Oh yeah, it's missing two panels. So we're missing two panels. Let's just have a go. Let's do the bumper for the back. Let's do the other headlamp. Oh. Okay, there's the rear bumper. Attach. Yep. There's the headlamp. Was he saying inventory full, can't pick? I can still pick it up though. Yeah, carrying. There you go. Headlamp two. So I've got two headlamps now. Yeah. Gold black. What's golden black? The coffee. It's got some milk in it, so it's not black coffee. And it's in a Fallout mug. Ooh. That makes it tastier, somehow. Right, and we said two panels. It looks like I can only make one, and I can only make one door. Let's... Oh, yeah, there. Look, it does actually tell me at the bottom, installed. Not installed. Make a crude door. Then put that on the boot. There you go. Hey, we've now got a boot. Now got a boot on the back. Because we are going to need this at some point, I'm sure. Battery jumper. I mean, I don't know whether I should have saved all the... I don't know whether I should have saved all the materials and tried to make stronger stuff back at the base. What's that noise? Something coming towards us, maybe. Oh, I'm getting in. Put it in. Oh, that's in park. I get in drive. Oh, what? Oh, okay, no, it was in park, and now it's in drive. Oh, just knocked over something. Which is not the best. And I know this is maybe a bit reckless, but I'm going to try it. I'm going to try driving into the fence and seeing if I can knock it down. Hey, I can! Ha ha! Take that. It's got me inside. Although now it's like my bumper's damaged slightly. No, not quite. Actually, though, some of the bits of the front is. Yeah, it is. It's slightly damaged from me smashing it in. But now I've made it inside, so I'm not going to complain. Toolbox. Grab. Hello, Ayn. What's up? I thought you'd want to be here and get some snackos. Ayn's here. We give Ayn a snack. Want this little dog? Here you go. This treatos. Okay. Right, now I'll let you out. You want out the room?
No.
It's funny when he makes sad sounds, the poor sod. He's too cute sometimes. I mean, originally when we were doing all the, when I knew I was going to be cutting, like doing all the pencils down to little ones, I thought it'd be funny if after I'd done that, we did some drawing with it, but I wouldn't, I realised now, no, I wouldn't have wanted to do that because of me hurting my fingers. We seem to be finding plenty of resources at the minute, but I'm sure there's something nasty is going to happen at some point. It's got plenty of material there. This door doesn't open though, does it? Huh. So I broke in here, but then you can't actually enter the building. I thought we would be able to enter it, but never mind. Well, let's get in. And then let's have a look at this device then she put in the car. I still don't know what this is. It's got something to do with devices you can apply to the car. We don't have any devices on the car yet. Well, there's the map. Right. Oh, I see. So it's showing you all the buildings along the route in this area. So when I go around this next area here, there's going to be three more buildings. And there's one there. And these buildings look like they're ones that have the plasma on, which we need to collect. We needed to get 5 plasma. Charge required. It's probably for the device. Yeah. So, right. Let's start the car. Oh, oops. Let's have another little look around. Oh, now I can't drive. Oh. It wasn't parked. I must have... I'm getting a bit overzealous sometimes, I think, when I'm driving around. So, That car, that... I suddenly realised I scrapped loads of stuff off that car, but not off the other one. Might grab... Quickly grab that as we go past. I've left it. I've left the engine running, but you know what? I'll be quick. Scrapper. Yeah, just grab what we can really fast. And there's the summer tyre. But I don't know, I don't see any way to get the tyres off at the minute. Instead I'll try scrapping it and seeing if we get some items. Might be able to therefore use it to make a better one. Scrap is almost destroyed, but hopefully we'll be able to build a new one. Drive. I like how the mark has been put on the map. What is that? There's something flying around up there. Let's carry on for now. Let's ignore the flying thing and carry on. Oh, we've spotted some more over here anyway. That's one of the things we needed. Why are these pylons shooting plasma energy about the place anyway? I don't like the look of this. Oh no, the car! The car! Quick! Screw you! Zapped my car! Right, pick up everything. Well, I'm not letting it do that again. I mean, I'm a little worried about going near them myself, personally, but... you know what? We'll just charge in there and grab it. Oh, crap! No, no, it's coming for me! Oh, it fires on its own. Yeah. Well, I took out that one.
Well, looks like you're near one of the old guerrilla radio stations. That ought to be prime pickings for antenna parts. I've loaded its approximate location to your map. Look for an antenna tower up on a hill somewhere.
Nice. An anomaly. Spark tower. Okay. Scanned it. Well, is that the edge of the... That's the edge of the map, then. Over there. She just said that she put it on the map, did she? Root map. Ah, but you can't see the map... You can't see the local map on that screen. What's that? It's coming up with, like... extra dots sometimes, but... Oh, it's just the spark tower. Right, okay. Flowers. It's a shame that I can't run it at max graphics. I know this is a really, really, really good looking game. And yet, I can't do it without it killing the stream. Instructions?
Oh, shit. My. Where are our manners? Driver, we never introduced ourselves.
Not really. Tobias Barlow, former Artem maintenance manager. Oh, and here with me is Dr. Francis Cook.
I was a R&D scientist researching limb technology right here in the zone.
We live right in the mid zone. Just a hop, skip, and a jump over another big old wall from where you're at. Oh, and that old man over there? That's Dr. Ophelia Turner, former director of research and development herself. The mother of limb technology, the maven of electromagnetism.
That's enough.
Resident party pooper.
Electromagnetism. Ooh. Met some interesting scientists by the sound of it then. Right. Stop here and have a look at this one. I don't like that my car's electrified, but it is what it is. Well, there's another one of them, whatever it is, floating around. I don't want to be caught by one of those. I have a really nasty suspicion that something... Well, nasty. Now, there was a generator here. It was destroyed. I think I can hear one nearby anyway. What have we got? Backpack, yeah. What's that? A flare gun? Oh, a flare gun, but I can't carry it. Damn. I might need to go dump some stuff in the car. Is it coming this way? Well, there it is. It's an abductor. Does it tell me what that is? Dear Maggie, I miss you and the kids so much. I'm sorry I haven't written sooner. What the hell? I feel like they're meant to be like little things you can learn, but I wanted to tell me what an abductor actually is. Because that isn't really helpful. You found a... electronics. Right, so use scrapper. Yeah. Well, I don't want to be abducted by an abductor. That's for sure. Off a wire. This is a door. It's a grate. Resources. Oh, just dropped my scrapper. Didn't mean to do that. Toolbox. Resources. One of them's new. What's this? Scrap metal. Right. Have I not been finding much scrap metal before now? Maybe I just used it all. Hazmat cabinet. Locked. Need pry bar. Right. Well, we knew we were going to probably have to go make a new one at some point. Let's go do that. Dump a few things in the car we're not using, and then in the boot. Let's see. We are still using the hammer thing. Oh no, it's the scrap metal. Right. I've max stacked it. Ah, okay. Have I max stacked anything else? No. So 20 is the max. Get a 20 and they just cap out. I might start actually putting a lot of these resources in the car. Hopefully it uses the resources from the car. Can I just hit transfer? Oh, I can. Alright, do that then. Won't move that because it's max stacked in the car. Everything else I'll do. And I'll just arrange it in this bottom box. Cardboard boxes. Half of storing things. I think we'll keep the flares. I feel like at some point we're going to need the flares. We'll keep the health packs. But I'm going to go grab some of the other bits in a second. Doctors aren't coming near here, so I stopped in a good place. Right, pry bar, scrap metal, one duct tape. So it uses it directly from the car then. Right, down the end, pry bar. Nice. And we got some chemicals, gas cylinder. Chemicals. Did we see something else we'd found, but I couldn't pick it up? Where was it? The sounds they're making's well creepy. Our backpack. Here it is. That was a flare gun. Hooray. You know what? I'll put it next to the flares. That makes a bit more sense, doesn't it? Yeah, they look nasty. I'm not going to try and take them on right now. Should I carry on in the car and then... What have we got here? What is that? That part of the device? Yeah, there's one down the way and then there's a building in the centre of this area. The top of that hill. Yeah, I'm going to run. I'll run it. And over. Yeah, there's the second building. Oh, it's got rocks floating around. It looks a bit possessed by something. Not sure if I should be entering this. Have you found a pothole? It's not like any pothole I've ever seen. It's floating around. We can get in. Impact hammer. Okay, yeah, so I said no, the impact hammer's how we get in. Ready, fire. Ho-ho, nice. Ugh. No, that's a test dummy, not a person. All right. Tourists, what? Actually counts it as an anomaly. I like how the pictures of the anomalies in the screen, they don't match any of what we're looking at. Oh, ooh. There's a different door. A crate. Crate's glowing slightly. Right. Resources. Another crate. Resources. Jeez. The noises are getting well weird. Oh, the abductors are coming over here now. Better watch out. Lest they come for me. I really wish I had like something I could light the place up with. Well, actually, I guess we do have flares. Hazmat cabinet. Chemicals. Okay, let's get out of there. There's a car.
Radio vehicle. Station's up on a hill somewhere. Eyes to the horizon.
Well, that's interesting. It's showing me, like, the different doors. Scrapper to remove. Use to pry open. Oh, there's a lot in here. There's a crude panel. Damn it, I didn't need to craft one. It was one here. Right, take that. Can I pick it up? Or hit equipped? Then I can carry it, yeah. I mean, I don't know if it's useful like this, but I could put it in the boot. I think I could put it in the boot. I guess we'll check. Well, then again, there is a panel I can attach it. Hey! Nice, that was lucky. I guess while we're back, I'll stick some of the stuff into the cardboard boxes. And I'm not sure if I need to make a new scrapper, really. It's about to run out, I think. I maxed that one out then. That's all right. They're no good to me while I'm walking around anyway. The materials. Right, let's check up this hill. They were mostly safe, but what the bloody hell is this? It's like yellow and glowing. Can I scan it? Why can't I scan it? I can. It's a stable anchor. Whoa, 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 whoa. What is it? Why is it made a noise? Oh, something's come out of the ground. I don't like this. Can I put it back? Can I put it back, please? They won't let me. Will it? Or is it the ground stuff? A bollard? What's a bollard? I don't know. Let's grab what we can and then we'll move. Oh no, it's disappearing. This is all very weird. Can I put it in my... I can't put it in my backpack. Fixed pry bar. But like, oh! Just dropped it. Oh, there's one of the thingies. There, an abductor. I'm running back to the car. I'm going to try and put this in the boot. Maybe once it's in the boot, it will be all right. Use healing item. Oh, I'm hurt. When did I get hurt? Okay, pick this back up. Can we go in the boot? Hands only. There's nothing in here. Oh, wait, I can put it in here. Oh, and then it's removed it. Okay. I do not know what that was, but it was kind of creepy. Well, I might go back up and have another look. And there was an abductor. I think it tried to get its hands on it, but I managed to get away. Right, yeah, we saw this, but I need the crowbar. Backpack. Materials. A phone. Use scrapper to destroy. Okay. Plastic. Whoa. The ground just try and rise up again. It did rise up. But I'm inside the building, so it seems like I'm alright. Radio. Okay. Back out. It's creepy that that keeps happening at all. There was a box there behind this, though. I wanted to reach. Can I jump on it? This is gonna retract back into the ground. Yeah, there's a dumpster, which is stuffed full of resources. Okay, I don't want to get caught by that nasty. Let's check the last building. There was another building over here. It's weird, it keeps flicking stuff up at me every now and then. Oh, it's because there's an anomaly. Hot dust. I don't want to go inside that. Where was the last building? Have I lost track of it? Oh, wait. Is that it over there? I think I can see it. If I can visit to the last building, then we'll carry on. Wait, no, that's not a building. That's another pylon. We'll have to be careful. Careful. Ready. Fire. Oh, is that it there? We found it. I knew there was here somewhere. I'm going to check inside again, because like last time, there might be a device in here that you could use before we run off with everything. I'm scanning everything on the basis that that's how it seems to be giving me lore. Map computer. Want me to use Scrapper, won't it? The Scrapper's almost out. Scrapper's gone, damn it. I knew it was almost out. Should have made a second one. Right, toolbox. Okay, next. It's cabinet. Use pry bar. Pressurized cartridges. That's new, isn't it? Oh, yeah, yeah. Storage box. Big one. With another... Is that another panel? It is. Oh, okay. Right, equipped. Let's see if we can carry this back, then. Car should be... Oh, wait. Ah, but I want to grab that as well. Switch to this. The creepy noises is seriously disconcerting. Pick up RB. Yep. It doesn't look like I could put it in backpack anyway. It looks like it's saying it's too big. Which makes sense. There's some cars. But this is not... that down again. Drop. Left trigger. Yeah. Oh. Crowbar. Oh, there's a lot in here. Bumper, but we don't need the bumpers. Carry a lot of these flares. Let's check all the boots. That's empty. I don't want to go too near that. Let's leave it be. Let's back up. Carry on. Yeah, this is where we... Wait, did I check this one? There we go. This is where we deviated. So, right, let's go get the car. Oh, yeah, there's radiation. I just spotted it, actually, top left. I didn't notice that before. Maybe that's how my health was dropping. There you go, there's the other panel we needed. Nice. Actually, before we go, let's put what we can in here. There's a lot of resources. Filled the car, guys. Which is not a bad thing. Can we make a new scrapper? We're gonna need one before long. These big things, you could put them there like that. Yeah, didn't think of that until now. Just makes a bit more sense to me. Hang on. Close the boots, close the door. Let's get in and see where we can go. Set a new target there. And then hopefully these dudes are not going to try and stop me as I drive by. Might, but hopefully they won't. Bunch more cars, but now let's carry on. I don't want to get caught by whatever they are. Going a bit off-road is probably not the best idea. Imagine the car doesn't like that much. Oh, there's fuel. There's it's an actual gas station. Let's pull in the car to Big Dan's gas station. Okay, park, engine, port. Hey, it works. Slightly. Sounds a bit weird, but okay. Fill the car. Good. We not like these noises. It's actually quite chilling. Oh, this is a bathroom. Oh, I smashed it down, but there's nothing in it. That's the first time we've entered a door where there actually wasn't any point going in. Cans, scrap. I mean, the way everything's glowing is because they said that they basically explained that areas are all unstable and they don't stay stable for long. What was that we just found then? Canned food. Okay. I'll refill my health. Oh, in this area, it's like radioactive. Right, so I am taking damage over time. You can't stay here long then. Jeez. Right, open. See, I must have missed that before. So I basically almost died previously from not even noticing that everything's a bit radioactive. There wasn't much in there. Let's check that other building quick, and then we'll carry on. Right, so that weird noise is actually the radiation going up and down. I'll have to get familiar with that. Anything? Anything? Quick. It adds a lot more urgency to it, the game, then. You can't stay anywhere for long. Use a healing item. Okay, back in the car. I wonder if while we're in the car, whether the radiation doesn't affect you. Okay, cool. It's worth knowing. Let's have a look at this. Right, she recommended we go to that area, so we'll set a marker there now. And then there's one more building, and then I guess we're out. What? Well, hang on, what's that there, though? On the bottom corner. What are those? Anchor signal. Gateway ready. Dead end. Radio station. Cabin. She was going on about a radio station, wasn't she? Park a minute. Take it out of park. Beep beep. We're on our way from misery to happiness today. There's some more interesting looking buildings of some description. But let's just carry on around this corner for now. Let's try and deal with this radio station if this is the place. Overlook camping. This does look like a path going upwards. Oops. Oh, it's another thingy. Watch out, watch out. I don't want to get caught by it. I imagine it'd be tricky if you go around a corner and a flipping, like the ground starts rising up in front of you because of the anomalies. How far does this road go? It didn't go very far, but it seems to be going all the way up to the place. Here we go. But I'm a little unnerved about getting out here, but do our best. What's it doing? Is this the arc thing? No, it's something else making that noise, isn't it? There's no radiation here, at least. Is it this?
Well, time to get moving.
Picked it
the
up.
Instability's ticking up by the second.
Okay.
But you can't get back the way you came. The instability makes all routes one way. And that's where my arc device comes into play. It'll get you back to the garage, but it needs to be charged first. Don't you worry your pretty little head about how it works. You'll be out of here soon, so there's no reason to learn more about limb technology than you need to know.
Huh.
The arc device is charged and ready. You'll use it to open a gateway back to the garage, but it will immediately collapse the stability around you. So only activate when you're absolutely ready to leave. You do not want to get caught in the storm that follows.
Right, oh. Okay. Well, I'm wondering whether we want to visit these other places first. Although, ooh. What are those? They... Anchor Sid? What is that? What does it mean? Well, I say we head there and then we have a look at it from a distance. I forget I need to like rev the engine a little more. Oh, play. What's this?
Hey, Harpy, like, look, I keep thinking the way you're helping our friend here right now seems positively helpful. It seems like me. You're looking to turn a new leaf or something?
The only thing I want to look at is a 12-year-old whiskey. And the back of his breacher's head when I send them packing.
But isn't it worth taking a detour to run just a tiny little test?
Can't think of a worse way to spend my time.
Please. I've seen you manipulate waveforms with your right hand and knock back a double.
Oh, they're chasing me. Oh, crap. They're chasing me and they've stuck onto the car.
Is that you won't shut the hell up until I test this remnant.
Yep.
Fine, stop crowding my frequency.
What? Wait, really? Harpy, darling, you never give in this easily. What's going on?
Francis?
Yes?
How have you not thrown him to the bunnies by now?
80 years old and only getting sharper by the day. You're a legend.
You're a role model.
I'm giving you 10 seconds to get out of my...
Okay, we're signing off.
Hey, driver, good luck out there. And watch out for the bunnies. They are a doozy.
For the what? For the funnies, did he say? Oh, look, it's broke again. It's saying everything's locked. Which is not the case. I do need a... Yeah, I do need a scrap. My computer, same again. Lots of resources. Lots and lots of resources. Locked. Unlock. Ooh, grab. I almost didn't see that there. Radio. Grab everything? Most of it. It does sound like it's getting busier outside. Like stuff's moving around a lot more. Which is not necessarily a good thing. I did see a van and I kinda wanna check it out. Though. Is that it? This here? Like a truck. I don't know if there'd be anything useful in it. Steel door? We don't have a way to pry stuff off yet. Don't know if we'll be able to do that. Some. I can scan stuff. Tow truck. Might have a quick go grabbing what scrap we can out of it. Use the arc device to locate and drive to an anchor site, see map legend. Select gateway coordinates on the map. Right, so that's the part we're at now. Is that where they are, though? Anchor sig. If I the holding things just drives me a little bit confused. If I drive this way. Oh, there is. There's another one of these things. If I grab it quick, then I'll be able to put it in to charge the car. I'll just put it park for a second.
Those very anchors fast. May look like glowing balls of magic, but it's Limtech through and through. Don't be scared. They haven't exploded in anyone's face. Recently.
What's that over the corner? Is that something else to scan, or is that just another one of these? It's just another one of these dirt things moving around. Right, so it looks like they yeah, they're these things that you can grab and they can use that to charge it. And then we need to drive over here. So if I click link gateway. Oh crap! Something's happened. If the car's been flipped. They flipped the car. Oh wait, hang on. Health critical, because it just knocked me into the air. Activate emergency teleporter. Scanning for warp location, warping vehicle. Oh, so if that does happen, you can warp it. This damn device is here, flipping. I'm just gonna grab it anyway. Oh, it's shooting me with lightning. But it's got two generators. So get both of them. Maybe a bad idea though. I got no more health kits. Can I pick that up? Good. Right, let's get back in the car, safe. And hopefully we're not gonna get flipped like that again. Let's head towards one of these locations. Quick as we can. There. Right, start the car. Oh, the car was started. It was just drive. Don't get flipped again. Turn, 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 turn. Turn. Come on, boys and girls, we're going for a ride. Heading towards this teleport location. Is that a... Is that? It's like a device in the ground. But let's not mess with it. Let's just carry on. Ooh, ooh, ooh. Car's taking damage from this. Oh, it's changed its mind. Hang on. It says I could activate them and then I got too close and now it says I can't activate them. Is that right? That's weird. Okay.
You see that glowing pillar into the sky? Drive into it. Yes,
that's the way out.
Half death, but it's so much better than getting scrambled by the instability.
That's the way out. Come on, car, go, 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 go. Yeah, so you can't do it from too close because that would make it too easy. This place is about to not exist very shortly. Drive. Drive! I know you still turn like a cow, but come on! Into the light! This game's so trippy. Oh, dude! And then it takes us back to the garage.
Oh, well, you're alive. I'm certain if the zone didn't get you, that gateway would. Did I not mention that you're the first human I've sent through that thing?
I mean, there have been rodents, but it's not like it's completely untested.
Really?
But anyway, it worked. So, you should have made it back with everything you collected out there. That's the beauty of the gateway. It's the only way to get back with all your marbles intact. Now, take those parts you found into the back room. I'll let you use my fabrication station. For now. That station will concoct ways for you to rig up anything from roof racks to flare guns. Assembling an antenna with those parts you brought back should be easy as pie. But it requires anchor juice to work its magic, so bring back as many as you can. And just because I haven't used that garage in decades doesn't mean you can trash the place. Mess up my equipment and I'll throw you to the anomaly so quick you'll get whiplash. We clear?
See how's it? Paint shelf. All right, so you can store the paints you find in there. That's cool. So we'll take the paint out. That's cool. Charging station. Then everything turns back on. Why is it still locked? Impact hammer. All right. It's funny she lets me destroy the doors. Out, in. For what? Nothing in them right now. Fabrication station. Scanning antenna. So this is what you use to, like, basically make equipment for the car, is it? X by slot, X by garage. Garage survival tubes. Anyway, scanning antenna is the first thing. You need the transmitter. Well, that's in the car, but it looks like it's taking it out anyway. Plasma and scrap metal. Oh, there you go. It's created me the scanning antenna kit. We now, what, store that in the car? Or does it go on? It looks like it goes on the roof. Huh. Okay. Up we go! Oh, nice. Is it done?
Antenna signals coming through loud and clear. Give it a moment to initialize.
I think it's a clever game, this. I think it's really cool. They've managed to make a really interesting gameplay loop for a driving roguelike, basically. Get the handbrake from the back room storage. Wait, why do I need a handbrake? I thought the car already has a handbrake. Huh. Oh, it says you can turn it into skids. Okay. What? Equipped? Then install it in the car. Install handbrake.
Sure to empty your trunk before heading back out. You'll need the space.
Empty the trunk. But where should I empty it to? Is the question. Oh, search the dumpster for something to help you unload the trunk. Thank you, dumpster. That's so random. Inventory full.
And what did we're it, patched. What did Everything's in working shape, more or less. I've hooked up the antenna to the route planner. Give it a look after you're done peeping through my garage.
A transfer trunk. Okay. What do I do with it? Do I put it somewhere? Does it go somewhere? Pack survival tools. Battery jumper, road flare. I'm not sure what I'm supposed to do with this. object. The heck is that? Oh, that's to help you transfer stuff out of the boot. Right, I get it. That's what it's for. Okay. It just generally lets you pick stuff up. Oh. Everything's just moved up. Oh, because it lets you move stuff out of the trunk really quick. You can click transfer materials just by clicking in the right stick. I noticed the minute you put it down, the boot close or not? Oh, I don't know. Show me which of the panels are damaged. And then I could put them in here. Yeah, so you can just immediately move all the materials in there, and then I guess I could just put the trunk on the ground next to it. There's multiple lockers, eh? Yeah. What's in here? There's a hand vac. They said you needed that to suck out some materials, didn't they? Yeah. Repair putty. Food. Crude bumpers, crude panels. So there's some spare ones if you need them. Is there anything we want to repair right now? Yeah, I wondered if we could start making better car parts. I know, we can still only make crude ones. Nothing better. In case your engine goes. Oh. Bumpers, crude panels. Anything that's looking a bit dismal, I'll repair. Stuff on the front, for example. the bumpers and stuff are generally all right. Steel door, some tire, crude panel. Rear door, rear bumper. Not too bad. Well, the steel door does have a crack in the glass. Maybe that's what it was talking about. I don't know if that'll... No, it doesn't repair the glass then. Glass is just cracked regardless. Right, what do we have in here? It's two repair putties. I don't see the negative in... like stacking it. What's that there? Put it in. Yeah. I don't see the negative in stacking as many as we can. Damn it, I just picked it back up again. Because it will take up a slot regardless. Oh. What just happened? Won't let me stack it then. Sulfur and let's empty out the materials. Hey. Canned foods are good. Quick health boost. I'm obviously going to need the other items anyway. Hammer and crowbar. Suggesting I build a battery jumper? Fill your tank, prepare the car. Oh no, I've not fully repaired the car. Okay, so it won't let me do that yet. Picked it up, but I didn't equip it. Quit. Okay. Wants me to fully repair the car then. Might as well do the tires. I imagine they can get damaged quite quickly. It'll be nice when we can actually, like, you basically will be able to get the car to the point where it's in much better condition then. Obviously wants me to get everything back to 100%. Oh? Done? No? Something's still not done. We didn't see the engine. Repairing the engine's probably a good idea, actually. Is it repairing it fully or not? Oh, it didn't. Probably takes a lot to repair the engine then. It stops, it's still not even fully there. Okay, I'll get out the other one. After all, after doing runs, you'd obviously be able to make more anyway. Have a look to the wing mirrors. No, they're all right. Okay, one more on there. The headlamp was quite damaged. Bumper. The headlamp. Okay, that should be it. Oh, I've got to scan that. I realise now it basically says whether you've scanned stuff or not. Oh, sealing kit to fix the crack, right. How much is a sealing kit? It's not too much. And it wants a battery jumper to make this other hack. Where's the boot randomly shutting itself. Trunk storage. Trunk storage empty. What's that referring to? Don't know. But anyway, sealing kit. Now let me fix the window. Magically fixed the window. Battery, fully charged. Engine. Fuel. Gas cap. There was a gas cap there, but it's still full as well, so there's no need to do anything to it. It was going on about something else, but now it's not listing it. I don't know what it was, why it wanted me to make that. It was going on about something. Wasn't something you can craft then? No. So we now have a battery jumper, which we can carry in the boot as well, along with, there's not much, but a bit of repair putty. What does the flare gun even do? to hurl flares into the world than risking a strained arm on the embarrassment of a poorly aimed throw. Because we've not really been using the flares, but I'm guessing the point of the flare is that you can use it for light. Right. Spat something out. Again. Plasma. What was this device? Vargas Autovac. Oh. Which is... dropped the transfer trunk here? Oh, it is. Maybe it just picks up everything that's on the floor and then spits it out here. Funny that. Oh well, I'll just put the transfer trunk back where we wanted it. There. You know what? We'll open that door and smash our thing anyway, and then we'll make a new one. New pry bar. Nice. I think that's it though. I don't think there's anything else. Find your way to town. There's the monitor. The car, yeah? So it tells you if there's any issues with the car.
Ready to make this remnant verification a one and done thing?
Is that your car?
I'm
yeah.
You
so this is your car in the game. And as you drive it around,
car,
you'll
then we're free from Tobias's fever dreams and we can get you out of here.
You'll slowly improve it.
Detect stabilized road junctions in the outer zone. You've got a stable route heading straight to Cappy's front door, but the energy readings are off the roof. I advise you not to take the zone lightly. You better gear up or you may not survive the trip, which would make my life easier, so your call.
So it's like you slowly improve the car over time. Do you think we could pry the door open or it's not going to let us? No. Yeah. Didn't realise you would be alive after I was done with work. How's the game? It's very good, Eifusa. It's been quite good fun. So it's an interesting gameplay loop. It's that you've been sucked through a portal and you're now in this. You're now in some part of wherever that's a rather unstable sort of mini pocket dimension or reality or something like that. This garage is one of the few places that is actually stable. And then you travel using this route planner to locations that then basically that's where the rogue like element comes into play. They're all sort of like procedurally generated locations that exist because they're unstable locations, and the minute you leave them they fade back into non-existence. And but you're gathering resources in a roguelike that then you use to, in a survival style gameplay mechanic, improve this car to make it better and better. Giving it strange equipment. It's kind of like, it's almost like your own Ghostbusters rig. I mean, look, you've got this arc device here that uses the map, which is then also how you warp back here as the place basically starts to collapse around you. It's quite trippy. It's quite trippy. Very clever idea for a game. I've not got too much to make at the minute that I can make. I guess it depends on where they're heading now. They want me to go to town. But we're probably going to wrap up because it's already 11:30. And I've only done one location. I wonder what this is. I bet you this is going to be something cool as well at some point. Bunch of switches. Big flashy switches. You've ended up making your way to a garage that's owned by a scientist who's been researching the location. There's also a mystic dumpster, which seems to be possessed by some of the weird stuff that's in these areas. That just randomly keeps giving me items every now and then. No, he doesn't want to give me anything else now. No, he's had enough. Thank you for what you have given me though, Mr. Dumpster. I'll just pop the resources back in here. Shame though there's no easy way to organise it. We've made a pry bar, but it's purple now. Does that mean it's better pry bar than it was previously? I did admittedly make it at this... I didn't make it on the road. I made it here on this workbench. I don't know if it has an improved... No, I don't think it'll be better than normal. We could do with some at least a first aid kit before we go, but I'm not running anymore right now anyway. But I thought it best to put some in my pocket. So we've got some canned food and a health pack, a crowbar, a hammer and a scrapper. It looks like it's got decent music and everything else as well. So no, I've been quite pleased with this. It'll be a good bit of fun to mess about with. Every now and then. Yeah. Right, I'm gonna quit the menu so that it isn't messing with the OBS anymore. and then I can turn on the preview and see my pretty face. See my pretty face again. No, that screen's now black, but I'll just put it on there so there's something on that screen. That's been quite fun. Today's been interesting. I have to say, didn't realise my green screen was showing. It's probably because we've been messing with the camera and everything. Yeah. Well, that's been fun. So thank you again, Eifusa, for requesting the pencil sharpening speedrun, which we did in 55 minutes and 58 seconds. Sharpened 10 pencils down to their nubbins. Their nubbins. Right. We'll see. We'll have to see next week then who wins the video game request auction next time. So get ready to put in your bids next week, guys. We'll head now then to the chatting channel, to the chatting TV, as it is time for one last raid royale before we do carry this party, for those of you on Twitch, to someone else on the internet and whatever they're doing today. Maybe we could find someone doing some... Actually, yeah, there's a good example. I thought he was playing the new Final Fantasy. He's not. He's playing Final Fantasy Online. Oh, okay, well, come on then. Find someone else maybe playing Final Fantasy Online 7. I'm sure it'd be interesting to just have a gander what they're up to on there. Though I haven't got... I surprisingly don't have many people doing it. There's Mr. Happy. But I'd feel a bit embarrassed raiding Mr. Happy. I've got a raid target. Do you, Eifusa? Oh, give us the lowdown then. Give us the lowdown. Okay, right. While I check them out, then now is the time to...
Choose your fighter.
Right, say something in chat. Your avatar was born below. And then we'll proceed to the battle floor. And then I'll have a look-see then. Let's have a check out of this Hagen 15. I'll pop that in there. Right. Who's also playing Pacific Drive? Ah, there you go. There you go. Right. that's a good jump over then, isn't it? Okay, everyone's ready, because it's time to fight. Let's do this. Oh, it's pronounced Hagen, is it? Gen?
Three. Like that. Two, yeah. One, go!
We have Funny Man, Zez, Hasty Channel, Zellion, can't still pronounce it right, Eifusa, Stu, Kristen, Endless Sanctuary, Gabby!
Everybody fight.
Oh no, Stu, you're out! Oh no, you're not. You've got the tiniest sliver of health. He's chasing you down, Eifusa. Oh no. Rocket launcher to the face. Gabby's out as well. If you pull this back, Stu, that will be very impressive. You've rocket launched Hasty Channel to the face. Now it's you versus Zellion. Ooh. No, he just got you. Zellion won!
Game!
There you go. Well, Zellion then. Zellion is the winner of today's last Raid Royale. So good job, Zellion. You are now the VIP until the next time we continue this. Ah, see, look, his game's running. I'm looking at Hagen now. Hi again, and his game's looking so much better than mine. He's probably playing it on either a console or he has a second PC. I don't know why I bought it on the PC. I should have just got it on an Xbox or PlayStation. I've learned my lesson. No more, anymore. If a game can be played on console, buy it on console. It just doesn't work if I have to try and... most of them really struggle. Even though my PC is fairly good, but I don't have like the very top graphics cards or anything. So it's not too surprising that's the way it is. Okay. Right. So yeah, let's do this. Right. But I'm going to... We'll do our raid message first. Raid message. He's running a gig of Have You Done Your Homework? Who is? Hi again. Is he? Hi again. Yeah. Have I not, has it not come up with a message for us then? It normally comes up with the raid message. It's a stream ritual to say it every time. Let me try again. Maybe it's not. Maybe the AI is not being able to generate it. Oh no! There we go. We might post it twice now, which would be awkward. But there we go. There's our raid one. Vroom vroom. Pit's crew's here to turbocharge your Pacific Drive journey with some speedrun strats and all. Tons more users are using it. The AI. Yeah, I'm not too surprised. It's because it's quite good. I mean, look at that. That's pretty clever. That's pretty on the nose. Slightly Wilson's pit crew. Like, he's just managed to come up with like almost exactly what you needed to say. Yeah. Oh well. Yeah. Well, brilliant. Come along if you are on Twitch and say hello to Hagen. I do hope everyone has yourselves good evenings, weekends. Thank you for coming to another episode of the Slightly Wilson Show. We'll see you next time. And as always, folks, don't touch that dial. It's reading time.